Ladies and gentlemen, we're back on a special Thursday night edition of the Hot Tag motherfucking podcast. It is yours truly, the angry, big-spending wrestling fan, the man from the city of brotherly love, the man that was yelling his ass off at House of Hardcore, known as Shaheen, and my co-host.
I am the box man.
The hungry man eating the beef jerky.
I am. I'm eating some original beef jerky right now because I don't like any other stuff.
Oh, you gotta get a teriyaki, dude.
I used to get a teriyaki, but I don't know, man. I just started liking the original. So that's all I've been getting lately. Sometimes I get the peppered if I'm in a, you know, a mood.
Yeah. Yeah, you gotta get the Chinaman beef jerky, man. Teriyaki's where it's at.
That ain't too bad.
Yeah. Well, we do have a lot to talk about this week, so we're going to try to kind of breeze through it because we both kind of hungry and we haven't had time to eat and we're not trying to sit here until 11:30 at night, so we're going to try to breeze through this shit. Anyway, have you been watching the network this week?
Which is pretty- I have not.
All right, so I'm guessing you didn't watch ECW Exposed then.
No, and I really wanted to watch the Macho Man thing too, and I did not get to. I was actually upset.
Oh, man. I purchased the Blu-ray. It's fucking awesome.
I figured it was.
That was great. But, ECW Exposed, man. I guess we'll talk about it next week. I don't want to spoil it for you, but.
No, you can go ahead.
It was a cool concept, man. It's, you know, it's original content. It's something that doesn't really cost them much money. I like how it went live. The only thing that really irritated me was just, you know, Joey Styles mentioning the parental controls every 5 minutes. Like, dude, I get it. People have kids. You need to, you know, make note of it, but not every 5 minutes. You know, you put a fucking disclaimer down there every 5 minutes, but don't stop the conversation and keep telling the folks how to use, you know, the parental controls and all this shit. But overall, I thought it was a pretty cool little hour thing they had going on. Yeah, it's, you know, little stuff like this adds to it, man. If they do more of this stuff, I would be much more satisfied with the network. But, again, I'm not trying to come off as a complaining man right now, just yet. But, yeah, I love the network, man. I fucking love the network. There you go.
I just need more time, dude, because I just don't have the time to watch it.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't watch much either. I mean, I haven't watched pretty much any of the Monday Night Wars. I haven't seen any of the countdowns. I haven't watched pretty much nothing that's been original other than the Ultimate Warrior documentary and this.
Yeah, I watched all of those Ultimate Warrior stuff that week.
Yeah, this was really good though, man. This was really good, but I guess there was a rib in the show, which was really odd. Because out of nowhere, they just had like a fucking little trailer for a show that was basically just like America's Funniest Videos, just with like poodles and little dogs. And it was so random and awkward. It's just like in the middle of an ECW show. They just start advertising a show about a bunch of puppies and shit. And yeah, they came back and Joey Styles basically said it was a rib. And I didn't really get it. It was just weird.
Yeah, that... Okay.
Have you heard of this?
No, but, you know, you gotta rib the ECW guys. They're not WWE.
Yeah, it was so weird, man, because it just... I don't know, I've never seen anything like this before. I've never seen, like a show being ribbed live on air. This is weird. But, yeah, they had footage of a bunch of little puppies, and it was called Puppy Palooza 6, which was going to be airing on the network, which obviously it's not a real show, so don't go looking for it. But yeah, it was just weird. But I liked it, man. I think, you know, if you get some time, check it out.
Awesome. Yeah, I do want to check that out, and I want to check out. I keep hearing everybody complain about, not complain, but tell me how the Monday Night Wars stuff kind of is one-sided. So I do want to watch and hear the one-sidedness.
Yeah, but I expected that.
Oh, of course. I mean,
that surprises me.
That doesn't surprise me at all either. Yeah. But I do want to check that out.
Well, that's a lot of footage to invest your time into. That's 20 episodes, which are an hour long each. That's a lot.
Yeah. Isn't this a DVD, though, also? I think I have the DVD of this.
Well, they put out a couple of Monday Night War DVDs, but this is something different. This is a network exclusive.
Oh, a network exclusive.
There you go.
There we go. I get it now.
It is indeed. But yeah, I mean, I would like to check it out, I guess. I know they have a Lucha one that had, Rey Mysterio and all those guys on there. I want to check that one out. But as far as, I know people are probably going to hate me for this, but, just episode. I can't watch a whole episodes of Goldberg and, I don't know, DX. I've seen it enough, man. I've seen the whole DX thing enough. I've seen NWO enough. They've already put 16 DVDs out about them. They're on the countdowns. They're on everywhere, I've already seen all that. But, like the Lucha stuff is kind of cool.
Yeah, I would figure that is. I mean, especially with, all the Lucha stuff coming out now. It's probably a good idea to get in on it.
Yeah. I mean, I forgot where I heard this, but somebody made mention of it that, I guess they want to bring back the Cruiserweight title, or they had like some kind of poll on the WWE.com website. That was asking people if they want to see the hardcore title come back or, which one of these gimmick titles. And, yeah, the Cruiserweight was up there, which I wouldn't mind. But then again, I think we talked about this before, and I think you actually said, well, half the main eventers would be in the Cruiserweight division, which is true.
half your roster is going to be in there. I mean, think about it.
Yeah.
If you label, and then even Eric Bischoff said that was one of the worst things he ever did. Was label those guys as cruiserweights because it kind of pigeonholed them. And, whenever we tried to make them break out, didn't really work that well. Because, gee, I wonder why.
Right.
So, yeah, I don't know. But, well,
They never got the right positioning or opportunities on the card anyway, man. As long as Hogan and those fucking guys were around and they were writing their own checks and shit, basically, from what we hear. Jericho and these guys weren't getting a push.
Yeah, I just worry if WWE did something like that, it would turn out like the X Division, where you get these big, huge guys just jumping in there and killing the little guys.
Yeah.
Eventually. But I don't know. I mean, I could see... I don't know. It would either do one of two things. It would either hinder a lot of guys, or it would give some more guys some time to showcase what they can do. One of the two might actually help. Who knows?
I mean, if they have guys like Kalisto and those type of... I mean, Kalisto, he's really small. So that guy, I mean, I'd hate to break any dreams, but that guy's probably not going to be a main eventer. As much as I love Samurai Del Sol, but... You got to be honest with yourself. I mean, I wouldn't mind seeing a guy like that in the Cruiserweight. But yeah, then again, if you have guys, upcoming guys like Chris Jericho, and it would kind of pigeonhole him.
Yeah, I mean, but then again, like I said, it also could give some guys. I mean, you could throw, in there. I mean, you got guys like Zack Ryder and all these guys. I mean, they have such a big roster that. And they only push like 8 guys.
Zack Ryder, man.
Zack Ryder. I don't know. Any.
Cruiserweight. Yes.
Anybody. I don't know why I can't think of anyone right now. I've had a long day. But, yeah. I mean, it could help out a few guys, but I don't know. I don't think they'll ever bring back Cruiser. I think they would bring back the hardcore title before Cruiserweight title.
You think so? I can't see the hardcore title ever coming back.
The matches wouldn't be the same.
Yeah. Plus, I mean, honestly, do we need more titles?
No.
They can't even build up the ones they have now. Do we need more? Honestly, I mean, the U.S. title, this is the first time it's felt somewhat important since it actually ties in with the storyline with Rusev being a foreigner. basically, you know, taking the title away from the United States. I mean, that's actually, you know, building up the title a little bit. But aside from that, I mean, when is the last time the U.S. title had any kind of prestige to it? I mean, Dean Ambrose was the title holder for like a year and a half or something, man. He defended it like twice. They don't need more titles. Fuck that.
No, they don't. And yeah, it's funny that the U.S. title is now looking like it's actually making, you know, it's kind of making a comeback, and the guy who has it is not from the U.S.
Right.
That's cool.
Anyway. I like Rusev being the U.S. Champion, though. I mean, we've talked about it several times on the show, which, you know, we said that it would have made sense, and finally they pulled the trigger on it. I mean, I'm happy, but it took them long enough.
Yeah, it did. Well, JR says it was all his idea.
Really?
Yeah. Have you not heard the show?
No.
They finally did what I said and gave Rusev that title.
Man.
Again, we said it too, JR.
Anybody with common sense would I don't know, dude. I think common sense would kind of just play into that, and you don't have to be JR to come up with that. But
you don't even have a wrestling fan to know that would be good.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but as far as, you know, we're talking about the network, I guess you didn't see the Macho Man sneak preview of the DVD documentary, whatever it is.
No, that's what I wanted to check out, but I just didn't get to. I went to bed as soon as Raw was over Monday.
Yeah. Now I bought it the day it came out, and it's awesome, man. If anybody is gonna, you know, put money in WWE's pocket, this is a good time. Buy this. It's good stuff, man. Especially the match listing. It's not the typical, you know, because I hated this about the WWE DVD collections back in the day, man. It would be the same fucking matches on every DVD. Every DVD you got Andre against Hogan WrestleMania 3. I mean, I owned that match probably like 40 times on different DVDs.
Yeah.
After a while, it's like, all right, dude. I'm pretty sure everybody knows these matches. So this one has some random, like, I don't know, like house shows and Madison Square Garden matches and the Spectrum matches. So it's got a bunch of good stuff on there. Yeah, I would definitely highly recommend it. Definitely suggest you guys check it out. It's good shit.
Yeah, I need to check that out. I need to check it out. I need to get the DVD.
Good shit. Get the Blu-ray, man. Get the Blu-ray.
I'll pick it up.
Yeah, I stop buying DVDs, dude. The Blu-rays are so much better.
Yeah, I got a Blu-ray player, so I can do that.
Yeah, they got a bunch of extras and all this good content, so.
Yeah, nice. I will definitely pick that up, probably this weekend.
But not to spoil it, I'm not going to go into it until you watch it, but I'd like to talk about this for a second. I thought this was interesting. They actually kind of hinted at the whole Stephanie thing, which was weird to me. I didn't think they were going to do that.
What was that? You broke up for a second.
The whole Stephanie rumors with Macho Man.
I read they were going to address that.
Well, they I wouldn't say they addressed it. They kind of hinted at it, but I don't know, man. But it was interesting because now it kind of gives you that feeling like, okay, there's more to it than it just being a internet rumor, you know? But yeah, I didn't know. I guess Macho Man put out a video basically saying that he's going to steal Stephanie from Triple H, and that's where the rumor started to stem from. But yeah, they showed the footage, and yeah, it definitely sounds like he banged a young Stephanie, man.
Man, and the rumors are she was like 14.
I think she was 17, they were saying on the... Well, they didn't talk about it on the DVD. I don't know. But if it was 14, then that's sick. They're not sure how old he was when this happened. Because it could have been in the 80s. I don't know.
Interesting.
I don't know, but I'm guessing it probably had to be in the early 90s, right when he left. Because on the DVD, they definitely gave you that feeling that Vince wasn't happy with his departure and the way he left, and, you know, Actually, I was surprised that Vince didn't talk about it at all on this DVD. He had no appearances on the DVD at all.
Who had talked about that said, I was watching a shoot interview, or maybe, I don't know, maybe I was listening to a podcast, and they were talking about how, you know, when Vince turned on, you know, when Vince saw Randy on WCW, that it really did hurt him because he didn't know he was going. So, I don't know. They said it really, Vince really thought of him as like a son, and it kind of really hurt him. So, I don't know. I really like to sit and pick someone's brain that knows all about this whole thing, but that'll probably never happen.
Well, never say never, man. But
good point.
I mean, Vince has felt that way about damn near every single wrestler out there, you know. So, I mean, that's not a surprise to me. I mean, he felt like that with Kevin Nash. He felt like that with Scott Hall. He felt like that with the Ultimate Warrior.
Yeah, true. Well, you could see when Warrior came back how much that he really cared. He was happy Warrior was back. You could see it in his face.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. Every single... It was good to see, I think.
Yeah. Well, let me see what else we have on
here. You got phone calls going on over there?
No, it's telling me to upgrade the YouTube thing.
Oh.
Which is really annoying. I don't know.
Yeah, sounds like you're hammering in a fucking railroad tie.
Did it stop?
I think you got it off. Yeah, it stopped. It was kind of weird.
Oh my god, it's back! What the fuck, YouTube? Why are you doing that, man? Stop! All right, if you
please
hear
don't
me,
make me go on Skype.
Man, fuck you, YouTube. Why are you doing this?
Man, we've been talking about how bad Skype sucks, and look at this.
Yes. Trying to make it upgrade.
Oh, if it's going to do that the whole time, we might need to take a quick five and get it done.
Okay, hold on 1 second.
Because it sounds like you're hammering fucking steel.
This is amazing.
It's awesome. Yeah, man, that fucking Skype blows.
Why, man? I already upgraded it. I just upgraded it. Son of a bitch. Why? All right.
And you can't even mute your computer. That's funny. All right, got that off now?
Take over for 1 minute while I figure this out. I'm going to put it on mute.
All right. I can do that. We can take over. I can take over. Whoa, let's see. We were talking about that and the network, and I wish I had more time to watch the network. But speaking of television and all that stuff, it looks like WWE also signed a multi-year deal with Warner Brothers Home Entertainment. Looks like they got a new distribution, some new distribution formats as of January 1st of next year. So, that's not bad. Good for them. They do have a pretty big company going at them now. They've usually got smaller companies, but good for them. Now they got Warner Brothers distributing their DVDs, which is a little weird since they do have the network. They can just distribute them right there. But, anyway, it's not that big of a deal, I guess. Not that big of a deal, I guess. But who cares, really? So... there's that. And what else we got here?
All right, I think I got it now. No!
Oh, man. Oh, he's back on mute again. Why don't we do this? Why don't we... give me 1 second here. Also, it looks like, we were talking about Ultimate Warrior a few weeks ago, it looks like WWE and Ultimate Creations, which was one of Ultimate Warrior's companies, now are getting involved in a project together. which is good. And give me one sec, I'll find out what that project is. We will find out in just a second. Bear with me here, folks. I wasn't expecting to be by myself for a minute or two. It says WWE and Ultimate Creations working on a new Ultimate Warrior project. What's up? Got it?
I think so. No. Oh, my God. Why?
Oh. Awesome. We're getting there, man. We almost got it.
Man,
you almost got it.
All right, how about this? Let's take a quick break and
we'll take a quick break, and then when we come back, we'll talk about Ultimate Warrior and WWE and his company are doing. So we're gonna take a quick break. Give me 1 minute here. Let me get what we need, and we will be right back, folks.
And we are back.
Wait. Yes, we are. You were right. We're back. I was right. You were right. We were both right.
Yeah, we're back. No more hammering and steel sounds.
You were on the railroad, hitting railroad ties with a sledgehammer.
There you go, man.
All right. No.
We're making fun of the Chinese before.
Right. Oh, man.
What?
Oh, man, I'm not even sure. I'm not even sure what to do for that one.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, right before that, man, right before that, I was about to talk about, where was I here?
I don't know. We're dropping Hiroshima's tonight, dude.
Yeah, obviously. Damn, Pearl Harbor their ass.
There you go.
This was about Warrior, Ultimate Warrior, which is his company was called Ultimate Creations, and WWE had got together, and they're doing an Ultimate Warrior project. And they're looking for the help from you, the fans. They want you to record a video on YouTube saying just three words. Thank you, Warrior. Email it to them at their email, which I have posted on our Facebook, and they want you to share it, and then it looks like they're going to pick a winner.
All right. Thank you, Warrior.
Yeah. Thank you, Warrior.
All right.
I don't know.
Listen.
Pretty cool that they are at least doing something with WWE. That's good.
Well, he's not doing anything with WWE. He's passed away.
They. His family.
Too soon?
I don't know.
We're stating facts.
Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
All right, there we go.
By the way, man, Booker T is the worst. Can I just go ahead and say that? Booker T is the worst.
That wasn't even... That, I'm telling you, that he said in an interview, that was where he got that from, was from the movie The Warriors, which, by the way, is one of my favorite movies.
Yeah, but Booker T is pretty bad nowadays.
Of all time.
Nowadays.
Huh?
I don't know. What was that?
You walked up for a second. What'd you say?
I don't know. I don't know. I think we got tapped by a ghost. Or something. I don't know what happened. But I just heard somebody else, and it wasn't you or I. So whoever the fuck is out there, welcome to the hot tag. Apparently we got a third person hosting now. What the fuck is going on here? Yeah, I know. Like, it was somebody talking. Anyway.
You pick up this. Tap into another conversation.
There you go.
All right.
What about JR? Being on the commentary team for Global Force.
No, we didn't talk about JR being on the commentary team yet.
Yeah, I think they were also trying to get Mike Tenay, but apparently TNA is not really trying to do that, which doesn't really make sense to me. It's one show. It's not going to kill them. If anything, it's probably some exposure. Why not? But I'm actually looking forward to this show, man. It should be pretty good. New Japan Wrestling presented by Global Force Wrestling.
I'm definitely watching. Yeah. I'm definitely gonna check it out.
Wrestling boom is coming, folks. Wrestling boom.
You almost have to check it out. You almost have to see if it's going to be a, you know, is it going to be a great show or is it going to be a total failure? You almost have to check it out because, I don't know, man. Jeff Jarrett might be a complete tool, but he's got me interested in watching this shit somehow. I don't know. Maybe he's got a thing there with the selling koozies and shirts and 8x10s before anything even happens because I want to see if this is going to be a failure, if it's going to be a badass show. I'm curious.
So selling 8x10s and trucker hats drew you in?
Dude, this guy knows what to do, man. I mean, come on. Obviously, he's got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back next week. I don't know what the fuck this guy is talking about.
This guy is completely revamping how to do business in the wrestling world.
Man, selling 8x10s before a roster. That's good.
What roster?
Exactly. What roster, man? What roster?
He's got a bunch of Japanese guys and ROH guys as his roster. Guys who already have jobs are his roster.
Yeah. He's a distribution company, man. He's not a wrestling company.
He is. And like I said, if he wants to just be a distribution company for wrestling companies overseas, I have no problem with that. Matter of fact, we could probably use somebody like I think I said this last show. We could probably use something like that. It's not a bad idea. Just let us know that's what you're doing. You know, just clue us in.
Yeah,
that's all.
Yeah,
that's it.
I honestly just. I guess I don't know, but I don't know, man. I would appreciate it if he just told us that he's a distribution company.
I think that's what he's going to end up being. I think he's going to end up just distributing a bunch of different shows, but I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm down for whatever he does, so we'll see what happens. I'm definitely going to watch this show. Something's got me curious to see if it's going to be a total disaster or if it's going to
be... Parker hats in the 8x10s.
I'm telling you, man. If we weren't making fun of him so much for selling 8x10s, I might not give a shit.
The only good thing about them, honestly, right now, is JR. So I'm not even that's speaking volumes, but
yeah, love it if they got Schiavone.
Then again, Schiavone was on. He was on JR's podcast, and he was the worst dude. All he said was yeah, no, yeah.
A lot of boring. He's a radio guy. Cheer the fuck up.
Yeah,
he was kind of boring. You know what? People can ridicule me. I'd be trying to get Punk to do commentary.
I would want to do it. Because he's done with wrestling, man.
I know, but I would try. I would at least make a play for him. If they haven't yet, they may have, but I would make a play for him. I think he'd be I think JR and CM Punk doing commentary on your show, that'd bring in some viewers, I think.
Yeah, I think he's just done, man. I don't think he has any interest in wrestling, which is really odd because here he is, Mr. Pipe Bombs, and now he's, you know, as quiet as ever. What happened to the Pipe Bombs, man? Perfect timing right now. He has no boundaries
out there.
So
I don't get it. I don't know, but me personally, if I owned a company and was doing what Jeff Jarrett is doing, I would make a play for him. He could say no, but I would make a play.
I'm sure he has.
I wouldn't even want to guess what Jeff Jarrett is up to.
I'm sure he has, man. I mean, it would make sense. He's probably the top guy right now that's not, you know, signed by anybody. And I'm not sure if it would necessarily work. I don't know if he's actually going to bring in any ratings. I mean, I'm sure he's going to bring in ratings, but I don't know if he has what it takes to turn around a company like TNA or launch a company like Global Force, but I just don't see CM
Punk. Yeah, and I wouldn't get Punk wrestling. I would just want him on commentary. People would tune in just to hear what he's got to say. I guarantee it.
Yeah, I don't even think he wants to do comp. I just think he doesn't want to have anything to do with wrestling.
And I don't blame him. I mean, good for him. Maybe he just wants to get out of it for a while, take a complete break, rest up, and heal up. That's fine. Good for him. He's got the money. He can do what he wants. But I don't know. I would at least try. Worst he can say is no.
Mr. Phil Brooks of the Talking Dead fame.
Yeah. Interesting.
And honestly, if he doesn't want to be recognized as CM Punk anymore, why doesn't he just change his Twitter and all that stuff to Phil Brooks?
Well, he came in with the CM Punk name, so he can take it wherever he wants.
True. I'm not saying it as far as, you know, dodging WWE, but if you want to get away from wrestling, just drop the wrestling name in general.
Yeah.
Hate wrestling so much. You know, apparently he like hates wrestling now, you know. He always makes fun of like wrestling fans and shit, which I don't really blame him. No, it's like, dude, these are the same fucking people that paid money to buy your goddamn DVD. You wouldn't have been anything without these people, but you know, now you're shitting on them, which you know, it is what it is. I mean, he pretty much is an asshole. I mean, this is nothing new. Everybody's kind of known this. He has this, you know, fucking attitude outside of the wrestling business, and he doesn't like being approached by fans and et cetera. So it doesn't really surprise me, but at the same time, it is kind of sad to see how he never really responds to any of his fans or anything like that. But I don't know, man. I wasn't really the biggest CM Punk fan. I always liked him. I always enjoyed his work, but man, I really don't care either way.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was great in the ring. And, you know, I kind of thought when he left, I'd be like, man, this is going to suck. Show. He was one of the reasons I watched Raw, CM Punk.
Definitely.
But
you can definitely sense his absence on the roster. I mean, but at the same time, it's like, you know, if he's not passionate about it, I wouldn't want him to be here. I mean, it is what it is. If you're over the wrestling business, you know, if you're tired, if you don't like the direction that it's going, you know, he's a grown man. He makes his decisions, and that's, you know, it's his life.
Yeah, I just wish I could have been a fly on the wall for that conversation when he quit.
Yeah. That would have been.
Yeah, I wish I could have heard every word of that. To really know, because no one really knows what happened. There's a ton of speculation, but no one really knows. I wish to God I could have heard that conversation, though. That would have been nice. So.
Now, do you honestly see him coming back one day to WWE?
One day, yeah, I do. 2-3 years down the line, maybe, I could see him maybe coming back. I don't see him going to a TNA. I don't see him going.
No. If he's coming back, he's going to the big leagues. He's not going Ring of Honor again. He's fucking.
No, I see him going back to ROH. I could see him going back for a little while to ROH.
I can't see it. I can see him making an appearance and you know, kind of co-sign one of his friends or something. But I don't see this guy going back to make his comeback for a fucking $500 payoff.
Colt Cabana is manager.
There you go, man. I thought that's what I was waiting for. I thought he was going to be the first guy to get a word out of him. I thought Colt Cabana was going to have him on his podcast and he was going to kind of air things out. And no, not a word. Nope.
No, he was just trying to be quiet about it. Good for him.
It is kind of weird how Cabana just never really talks about Punk at all anymore on his podcast. Not that I actually haven't listened to it recently, but, you know, last time I listened to it was probably like 2 months ago, but I haven't heard him make mention of Punk at all. So, did you lock up?
Listen, I've one. Yeah, you did too. It's okay. No big deal. We both locked up for a second. Goddamn internets.
You got locked up.
Internet can suck a dick.
Got locked up like nails, bro.
Damn internet.
Can you suck dicks?
No, no, sir!
Bullshit, I'll bet you could suck a golf ball through a garden hose.
Sir, no, sir!
Fucking internet.
There you go, man. Fuck the internet.
Man, we should just start playing some fucking sound effects all night.
Let's just take the night off and press on sound effects.
I've only got 4 minutes total of sound effects, so that would be a short show.
Okay. Anyway, let's talk about Lucha Underground, man.
Yeah, you know what? Let's get into some actual TV shows. Let's do that. Lucha Underground. I must say, I have seen the third episode. You have not. I'm not going to get too much into it. But this show, right now, this one-hour wrestling show, is probably my favorite show on television right now. And it's blowing the hell away on a lot of wrestling shows. I mean, it's right now, it's better than WWE, and it's better than TNA.
And it's definitely better than Global Force.
Well, you know what? You can't say that because you haven't seen what Global Force can do yet.
Dude, we will never see what Global Force is capable of.
That was me being devil's advocate. How do you like that?
Man, Jeff Jarrett was doing pro wrestling syndicate shows, and you know I'm definitely not disrespecting pro wrestling syndicate. That's definitely one of the companies I co-sign and I always plug their shit on here. But you know, if you're doing independent shows and you own your own wrestling company, supposedly, not really a good look.
I mean, if you're doing them to promote your own company, I get it. But yeah.
He was just working. It was for a paycheck.
You might have a point there. Yeah,
it's not, especially when you're working for like Ian Rotten. I mean,
yeah, who's known for not paying people.
Not even that. It's just you don't seem legit when you're working shows at, you know, IWA Mid-South and shit, and you're trying to launch your own company, and you're supposedly this big legend, former WCW champion and TNA champion and whatever he did in WWF. I think he was like the Intercontinental champion. Was he? I think he was.
I think you're right.
Yeah, I think he was. But, yeah, I don't know, man. He doesn't look like he ages at all, though.
No.
That dude has aged since 93, man. He looks the same.
He really does.
Yeah, it's literally been 20 years since he's aged.
Yeah, lucky him. Must be a, I don't know, hot wife or something. Might have something to do with it. Who knows?
Yeah, or maybe just you know, singing country songs, man. That's a form of therapy.
Thank God he's not putting out fucking albums like Michael Hayes, at least.
Oh man, Michael Hayes, that fucking guy.
I was so happy that Norrin was the one who listened to those songs and I didn't have to.
Yeah, so once again, thank you, Norrin Rad, for that. Because I definitely didn't want to listen to that shit.
We appreciate it, Norrin. Thank you for being our guinea pig on that one, because we did not want to listen to that shit.
Yeah. Well, Lucha Underground. Let's get into
right,
it.
Back to Lucha. You look at you bringing us back this time. Usually it's me.
Yeah, Lucha Underground. Let's go.
Lucha Underground, like I was saying, this show is, I'm really liking it. I love the cinematic, movie-like backstage stuff. I mean, they're starting to get some storylines going. You know, you can't exactly expect them. They're introducing new people each week. I heard they introduced somebody else this week, or maybe one or two people. But if you haven't watched at least the third episode, you have got to watch that main event.
Who was in the main event? Do you remember?
No. Give me a minute. I know one of them, this guy named Phoenix, who is absolutely fucking amazing.
Wasn't one of the guys like Pentagon Jr.?
Yes. Yes, yes, one of them was. And I mean, but this match was just absolutely incredible. I really don't know any other way to explain it, but it was incredible.
Yeah, I've only watched two episodes, and I can honestly tell you it is definitely, for sure, definitely 100% my favorite wrestling show on television right now.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
1 hour of wrestling goodness, you know, that's all I need. I don't need 3 hours of fucking, you know, the lazy cat or angry cat or whatever. Which, the cat was cute, I did like that. But it's, fuck, come on, man. This isn't Chikara. You know, I know Stephen McGreen, he mentioned, you know, it really is like Chikara, man. I think I said it a couple weeks ago on the show, it, you know, the bunnies and all this shit. At least Lucha, it is kind of silly, but I don't know, dude, it's something different. It has a different vibe to it. The way they filmed it is different. It just has a different vibe. I like it. I'm digging it. Yeah.
There you go. Exactly. It's different. It's different. There's so many, I mean, and you know, like I've said already, the way the backstage segments are set up movie-like, you know, and Chavo's awesome, dude. He cut a promo. Him and Vampiro did like an interview on the third episode. Chavo was fucking amazing. He was awesome. I mean, I really liked it.
It's funny, since he debuted in WCW, I think it was maybe like 97, never liked Chavo Guerrero, dude. I never liked him in WCW. WWE, never liked the guy. Never invested into his character. For some reason, Lucha Underground, from the two episodes I've seen, they were capable of drawing me into Chavo Guerrero. So, it's a miracle. Absolutely. That's why I like the show, man. They've actually kind of changed my way of thinking of Lucha wrestling in general, and just kind of gave me some hope.
And you know what? When the hour is over, I want more. I'm like, damn, it's over already? Shit. Right.
Or if you don't want more, or at least you don't want to kill yourself.
Yeah, I mean, I'll be honest. Good point. When Raw is over, sometimes I'm like, oh, fuck, man. Thank right. God it's over. And
especially when there's no payoff on the third hour. I mean, you watch for three and a almost half hours, and at the end, usually it's, you know, like Cena against Orton or et cetera. And it's like, all right, well, that's another 3.5 hours I'll never get back.
Yeah, and, you know, maybe the fact, you know, okay, I'll admit, it's the Lucha Underground has fresh matchups right now because we haven't seen a lot of the guys. So maybe that's part of why I'm liking it right now, because it's fresh, it's kind of new, it's different. But I don't know, man. I just don't see them going to the, oh, we're going to keep doing the same matches for, you know, 9 months. I just don't see them doing it the way they're going. By the way, that was Drago. Pentagon Jr. and Phoenix in that last match.
Gotta check that out.
Dude, I mean, this match had high-flying package pile drivers. I mean, this match had everything, unbelievable. And this Phoenix, man, can do some shit. He was using the ropes like a goddamn trampoline, but he was, like, balancing on it like a fucking tightrope.
Who is he? Did he have any prior fame for this?
Let me find out real quick. Let me get off this. Let me see. Phoenix wrestler.
Here we go. I'm just going to pop up with wrestler from Phoenix, Arizona.
No, his name is spelled F-E-N-I-X. So hopefully it won't, but it might.
All right. Well, hopefully you get something. But yeah, man. I mean, Lucha, we finally got some Lucha in the States. I mean, we've pretty much never had a Lucha show. I think, Triple A ever do any shows in the U.S. as far as, like, TV shows?
I think this is their first one.
Yeah.
Because this is a Triple A company. We keep calling it Lucha Underground, but it's really Triple A Lucha Underground.
Right.
So, I don't think so. Let's see here. I'm right on his wiki.
Wiki.
Good old Wiki.
Yeah, wiki whack. Let's see, professional wrestler after starting his, professional career. Let's see, he was
straight facts.
Atomic Boy, Gato Everready. His brother is Dark Dragon.
Yeah, I don't know any of these guys.
I'm looking, man. Give me a second here. Personal life. I'm looking at personal. Let's see. Personal life. His father, two brothers, a wrestler. His father worked as Fuego. Have you ever heard of him?
Nope.
While his brothers perform under the ring name Dark Dragon. That's his brother. Pentagon Jr. is his brother.
Really?
That makes a lot of sense on some of the fucking moves they were doing in the ring.
Yeah, I gotta check.
Those two had amazing chemistry, and that definitely explains why they had great chemistry.
So, I got something interesting here on the news.
He was Masera Oriental in AAA, though. Just, I don't know if that helps anybody either.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I cut you off, man. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Wait, was there anything else on the Lucha Underground from last week that you want to talk about?
I didn't really want to get too much into it since you didn't watch it. I'd rather you watch it first.
Yeah, next week we can talk about the third and fourth episode.
Yeah, I definitely wanted to just put out there that anyone who has not seen that main event, get your ass on YouTube. It is 7 minutes of some of the best wrestling I think I've ever fucking seen. Maybe, I don't know. It was great. Just watch it.
It's a high praise.
Yes, high praise from this show that people take so much interest in.
There we go. We got something here. We got WWE Hall of Famer Roddy Piper and Mr. Anderson appeared on True TV earlier this week, which seems interesting, but then once I read the rest of it, I don't really know if I want to check this out, but Piper was hired by a furniture store and proceeds to team up with other employees to rough up customers. Mr. Anderson shows up from a rival furniture store to confront Piper. You can check this out. I'm going to post a link, actually, for you guys to check it out. But I don't know. I guess they're doing, like, reality TV now. Is this the new thing?
Okay. So you walk into a furniture store to buy a lovely couch.
Yeah, and then they rough you off.
And there's Rowdy Roddy Piper. How you doing?
Yeah.
Mr. Anderson comes in. Hey, what the fuck?
Yeah, this is weird, man. I don't know about this. I don't think this is a good idea.
How many assholes we got in here?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I would flip out. That would be like a dream come true for me. I'd be like, oh my God, I'm getting beat up by Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Rowdy Roddy Piper.
You know what? I might have to check that out. I think True TV has an on-demand service on my cable. I'll check it out. Or has it come on yet?
I don't think so. I just posted the clip. So I guess...
Let me get into facebook.com/group/THTpodcast to check this out.
I had a gut feeling this was going to happen. Mick Foley possibly returning to WWE as a general manager.
Dude.
Enough of this.
Thank you. You just yanked the words out of my mouth that I was trying to come up with. Enough already.
Yeah, enough. I mean, as much as I love Mick Foley, man, I mean, the general manager thing is, I'm done with it, please.
Yeah, it's getting kind of old. I mean, it's so played out. And I mean, you know, even Lucha Underground has the authority figure, but damn, is he good. I can't.
Yeah.
He's so believable. He looks like a scummy asshole that you really want to punch in the face. So, I don't know. I'm on a real Lucha Underground kick. I mean, literally, I can't wait till the next day when it comes out. Like every week, I'm like, I can't wait. It's Wednesday. I can get it. Yeah, so
I'm digging it, man. I like it, man. I like Conan. I like the Yes, I mean, we're talking about general managers and enough already, but then again, Lucha Underground, they basically have an authority role, and the guy is good. The guy is good. It's different. It doesn't seem boring. It's not just some washed-up wrestler coming back and doing a bunch of scripted bullshit.
Right. Done right, it's not beat to death, and I'm going to go all the way back to Cyrus in ECW. That was an amazing storyline they had going with that guy. You know why? He wasn't wrestling, and he was good at what he did. He was just the network back then. You know, it was a good storyline, and I loved it. I thought they did it amazing. Paul Heyman really had that shit together.
Oh, yeah.
So it definitely can be done right, but when your authority figure, I'm doing air quotes, has three quarters of your show taken up, and yes, I'm referring to Triple H and Stephanie, it really takes away from the show, in my opinion. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I mean, I thought Stephanie and Triple H were on Monday night way too much.
Yeah, they always are. But I like Triple H, man. I don't really mind them.
I don't mind Triple H. I love Triple H. But I've always been a fan of his, but it's the same shtick every time. Come out, talk some shit, insult one of your wrestlers who you're trying to build up. I would think you're trying to build up your guys. You probably shouldn't be insulting your talent on live television.
Right.
And then just, you know, if someone makes an insult at him, he laughs it off like it doesn't matter.
Same formula. It's like John Cena all over again, man. Just no sells anything.
And that was one of the most awkward promos him and Cena had the other night, I thought. Yeah. And I know we're going all over the place, people, but just fucking deal with it. Okay.
We do this every week, man. We start talking about Lucha, then we go to the main event, then we go to the Lucha. Then we start talking about all the band. Oh, man.
Who cares? You know what? It all ties into wrestling, and that's what we're here to talk about. So
we do, man.
Yeah, two tears in a bucket. Fuck it. You want to listen to this show, you better have ADD like we do.
Ladies and gentlemen, we don't take notes. We don't have anything to go off of. We just say, hey, you ready? Yep. Yeah. I'm probably as ready as I'm going to be.
We pull up results and we go through the matches, but I quit taking notes because I was trying to get everything I had to say in, and it was just not right. It didn't feel good to me.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I think it's better like this. But, I mean, it's just, I mean, that was one of the most awkward promos. Cena's cracking 5-year-old jokes, and Triple H is up there giving 5-year-old comebacks. That was funny. That was funny. Shut up. Let him talk. I mean, I don't know. Maybe I should just go back.
I can tolerate Triple H no selling everything, man. When Cena does it, is the fucking worst ever.
But I mean, you know, you got Stephanie out there just being cunty, and I know she's good at it, but God damn, she totally tore down those wrestlers a couple of weeks ago. She treated them like they were in kindergarten.
Yeah.
I mean, I was laughing, but God, even Kevin in the chat room said the authority has been going nowhere for years now, probably months. He's right. It's a circle, and it's a horrible circle they're going in, I think. But that's just me.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, it is Vince McMahon's daughter. I mean, what do you expect?
Maybe I should slow down.
Vince McMahon is still burying WCW like fucking 14 years later, dude. I mean, what do you expect?
Oh, and then Triple H comes out and does, we picked them up at an auction.
Dude, I don't care, man. I thought that was great. I don't give a shit, man. WCW's dead so long. Who cares? It's done.
You know what? Here was my problem with it. This is a company that you're pretty much trying to really push your network with. Let's face it. If you really look at what they're, I mean, if you go to their corporate page, which for some reason I do go to every now and then, the highest rated stuff on their network is WCW stuff. Do you really want to make fun of that when you're pretty much basing your network off of that and your pay-per-views? Probably not the best idea.
Always do this though, man. They, you know, they're still bitter about WCW, you know, 14, 13 years ago, you know. It'll never go away, man. I mean, as long as Vince, Triple H are here, they're kind of butthurt about it, and it's not going to go away. Triple H is mad that, you know, in 93 he didn't get a proper push in WCW, and Vince McMahon is mad because he thinks that him and fucking Ted Turner were in some kind of blood war. So.
I don't know. They just need to.
He thinks he was in, you know, in the movie 300. He thinks that's what it was, the Monday Night Wars, but that's reality, but that's his, you know, perception of it.
I don't know why I just got a picture of Vince with his arms open and a come at me, bro. Fucking mem. Come at me, bro.
Well, I'll tell you why, because when he wrestled with the way he fucking carried himself, that's kind of give you that energy.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll tell you, as the way Vince carried himself, I almost thought he was going to take Eric Bischoff up on that little offer he was doing when he was, that little storyline when he was challenging Vince to a real fight.
Man,
I almost thought Vince was going to take him up on that.
Vince would kill him.
Well, Eric is a black belt. Let's not forget that.
It's probably a game.
According,
you really believe that?
Hold on. Who did I listen to that Steve Austin had on?
I guess he can, anybody.
No, he really is a black belt. He really is a martial arts black belt. And I forgot who was on the what show was I listening to that someone had a black belt on there that had trained Bischoff's son? God damn it. Because Garrett Bischoff, his son, is a black belt too.
Oh man, that dude! I don't care if he's a black belt, man. If I get my ass kicked by that guy, I'm gonna off myself.
See, I liked him, man. I thought he had potential. I did.
Oh, what did you like about him? The tramp stamp?
No, like, come on, no. He didn't have a tramp stamp. He had the gas station tattoo. His last name.
Oh, man, he was the worst, dude.
That's what he had.
Wait, did he have a tramp stamp? I think I'm actually... That was a different guy, wasn't it?
That's Lance Hoyt.
No. One of the Aces and Eights guys. He had the tramp stamp. I don't know if it was Briscoe or it was Bischoff. I don't remember.
It was Yeah, you just said it.
Briscoe?
Briscoe, Wes.
Yeah. Well, I take that back then, Bischoff. Sorry, you don't have a tramp stamp.
No, he still had a pretty shitty tattoo. Jesus Christ, I can't talk. A pretty shitty tattoo, though. So.
Yeah. Well, as long as it's not a tramp stamp, it's all right.
Yeah, let's see.
Did you say Lance Hoyt?
Yeah.
Yeah, where is he from, man? What, like, where did he wrestle? You sound
TNA, WWE. He was Vance Archer. Lance Archer.
But is he the guy that's it's like the IWGP tag team champions with Harry Smith?
He might be.
I think they were actually at House of Hardcore.
Huh.
Yeah, Lance Hall. Yeah, he was at House of Hardcore. So that's the guy that you were talking about. He did have a tramp stamp.
He did. I remember when he was on Jack's show, and Jack asked him about it, and he went, "No one's going to tell me anything else about it. I don't care. No one's going to tell me I'm gay for having it." He's got a point. No one is.
Yeah, he is a big fucking dude.
He is a big motherfucker.
Yeah.
You know who? Oh shit! You know who it was that? You know where I heard about the Garrett Bischoff thing? I just remembered. I'm sorry. I got to go back to it. It was Ernest the Cat Miller.
Oh, okay.
It was Ernest the Cat Miller who was talking about him, and he gave him his black belt. That was what it was. I knew I had heard that goddamn story. No one in the chat's helping. God damn you people. I can do it all myself.
You have to, man. You got to help yourself, man.
I mean, you're talking, and I'm racking my brain. I'm like, I heard this like 2 weeks ago. What the fuck is wrong with me? It was Ernest the Cat Miller on Vince Russo's podcast. Yep, talking about that. Exactly. Okay.
Okay. Man, that guy really got screwed, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he did.
They stole everything from that guy, dude. I mean, they stole theme music and gave it to the funk. His gimmick is pretty much given to the fucking, what are they called? The new guys, Big E and Kofi. What is that faction called?
A New Day.
Is that the name?
I don't know. I know that's what they're calling all the promos.
Yeah, I just thought that was like a fucking quote, just to like. No, a New Day's come in with these. Like, I hope that's not the name. That's even worse than Speed Force. Man, and that is terrible. The New Day? Whoa. WWE? What are you? Dude, please, just hire some of these fucking former wrestlers or something, man. Stop hiring these fucking writers.
Yeah. They're
called names and these gimmicks, man. This shit is terrible. And I know people always say I complain about everything. Dude, have you been watching Raw? I mean, how can I not complain, man? I mean, what do you want from me?
I agree.
That guy's coming out as fucking priests and shit. It's 2014, man. These gimmicks don't work.
True. I agree.
Just doesn't work, man. Los Matadores just doesn't work in 2014. Sorry. Work in 91 with Tito Santana. Not now.
You know what? It would work if they had Tito Santana as their manager.
Probably. Yeah, there you go.
Instead of... I don't even... I'm sorry. I was about to be rude, and I'm not going to.
we've already dropped a Hiroshima, so...
Yeah, you've already insulted every Chinese person out there, but whatever. I was looking to see if I had any. I don't know. I don't have anything, so whatever.
Man, this might be the show where we're pretty much scattered all over the place. What were we talking about? What the hell were we talking about? we finished talking about Lucha Underground. Then we... went back to news, and then Lance Hoyt came out. Now we're here.
Listen, if you want structure...
What happened to this guy? Did I lose him?
No, I'm here. You got me? Hey.
Yeah, you're still here.
I'm still here. Yep. You lost me for a second. We locked up, but no big deal. Hey, man, look, if you want a structured show, turn on your radio. Turn on the radio. Don't listen to this. I mean, if you want us, I mean, trust me, we can have. Hey, look, you want us to get notes and do this by a schedule? No. Ain't happening. We were.
Maybe you do. Maybe you. I don't know. Maybe they want us to do that, but I'm not.
If you want us to do that, go to the Facebook and let us know. Come in the chat room and tell us.
Well,
I don't. Doesn't matter, man. But yeah, I don't know. We have been all over the place tonight, but who cares? We talked to Lucha, and I didn't want to get too much into it. Let's see. We talked about the ending of Raw, so I guess we could just keep pushing through Raw if you want to.
Yeah. Well, Raw started out with Triple H burying WCW, which we already talked about, which I didn't mind. I know the fucking internet went crazy. Everybody said he pulled out his golden shovel again, and yeah, he kind of did, but, you know, I mean, it's nothing new again, man. I mean, we've seen this before. It's nothing. You see it on the Monday Night War specials, apparently. So, I mean, I haven't watched it. From what I heard, they're getting buried all the time. So, what do you expect? What did you want him to say? I mean, then again,
Triple H formula.
I mentioned it, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, but I think it's the Triple H formula. He comes out, insult. That's just it.
But then again, at the same time, man, you can't just say that he's burying all these guys, because he shits on guys like The Miz. Do you remember The Miz a couple months ago when he said that he's like a straight-to-DVD fucking actor and all this stuff? I mean, he buried his own company pretty much, so.
Well, he does. That's what he does. And I can't believe it's like he can't see that. He'd rather make a dig at somebody than think about what it does. Eh, whatever.
Yeah, that one literally buried the WWE, like, distribution film company or whatever they have. But yeah, he buries his own company, so what do you expect him to say about WCW, eh?
Maybe that's why Warner Brothers picked him up. They needed a new distribution company after Triple H made that comment.
There you go, man. That's probably the case.
That's fucking awesome.
But Kevin Steen, I guess, is debuting in December, so that's exciting, man. You looking forward to that? Are you looking forward to that?
I'm looking forward to see what he's like in WWE, wrestling the air quote again, WWE style. So yeah, I'm excited to see what they're gonna do with him.
Now, do you think he's gonna come out as like dressed as like a panda, and he's gonna be doing like comedy skits and humping like Adam Rose and shit like that?
Oh my God, I so hope so.
You hope so? Man, I hope not. Please, please.
Sarcasm.
Yeah, good. Please. I hope that, honestly, man, they might do this to him. He might come out in a panda suit, coming out with the exotic gay express, and then the next thing you know is he's humping Adam Rose like the bunny.
The exotic gay express.
So, that's something to look forward to for you NXT fans. You're going to get a panda humping a bunny pretty soon.
Awesome. How much do you want to bet? I'll get into it in a little bit. Go ahead.
Nothing. It's just awesome, man. I mean, that's great stuff.
I mean, yeah, how can you not, you know, how can you not be over exuberant for this, excited?
It's like the Discovery Channel on Mixed with Wrestling.
We'll get into that in a little bit, too.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's get into it now. We're kind of talking about news. So, speaking of Discovery Channel, I guess TNA is part of the Discovery Channel family now. They're going to be on Destination America.
Which I actually do get, so I'm a little happy about it, because I don't get ROH.
I actually get it too, so I'm kind of happy since I don't get Ring of Honor and I don't get Lucha Underground. So
see, I got to seek out now. I'll tell you right now, Lucha Underground is worth seeking out. So get on the internets and do it. But yeah, I mean, I don't get ROH here, and I just can't seek it out. I just don't. I don't know. I can't get into it enough to do it, but. Yeah. Good. I mean, at least I'll be able to get TNA. And, you know, some people are saying, oh, this is the death of them. This is it. It may not be. This station might put more behind them. They may advertise more for them because that's what Spike was missing, the advertising for them.
Yeah, but they're like, they have very limited.
Well, I think they're in, I forgot how many homes it was.
Not that much. I was listening to Brian Alvarez, and I think he said it's like, God, I don't want to throw just random numbers out there. But I remember he said it was something like it was half the amount that Spike TV gets. So
well, let me see if I can pull it up so we can actually give actual stuff here. Let me see.
we can be professional for once.
Yes, for once we cannot just
make up a bunch of shit and throw it out in your face.
For once, we're gonna try to do this right.
By the way, it is a fact. Vince Russo is in the WWE.
Exactly.
We are professionals.
Do it.
Yeah, man.
Professionals here. So let's see. I'm getting to the search results. Going right to the. The WrestlingInc.com here. Let's see. I think this has it here. It's one of these two right here. So let's see here. Excuse me.
Mike Bessler as well. I'm gonna send you the pictures, man. I keep forgetting to send them the House of Hardcore pictures.
Oh, come on, man. Get them out there.
Yeah. Well, you gotta remember, man, I've been sick for the last fucking, like, 2 months.
Yeah, you've been dying.
Yeah. I did almost pretty much die, so. Yeah.
Good, so let's see here. Let's see if we can find the actual information. This computer would speed the fuck up a little bit.
Well, while you find that, let me make note of this.
Good.
Roman Reigns, the man of charisma, is coming back in mid-December. So I'm guessing he's going to be in the Royal Rumble, and Daniel Bryan is supposedly coming back at the Rumble. And I also heard rumors about Sting making an appearance at the Royal Rumble. So what do you think about all that?
Sting!
Sting, the man called Sting. Woo!
I don't know. I like I said, dude, I'll believe Sting when I see it. I'm not even going to go from there. Let's see here.
I don't see it happening, though. Like, Sting just making a Royal Rumble appearance? I don't really see
it. You know what, dude?
Debut.
Yeah, Destination America is available in 52% of the country.
Really?
That's not bad. And everyone who has DirecTV has it. It's basically, you know, that's it. And I've got Verizon Fios. I got it.
Yeah, that's what
their highest rated show is 440,000 viewers.
That's horrible.
So if you bring over 500,000, even half of what you had, you're making headway on that station.
True. So you gotta take into consideration that TNA was basically taking money from Spike TV to basically run shows and do all this shit. So they weren't really doing well on Spike TV. Just imagine on a small scale.
Yeah, things are going to be different. I would assume you're going to see a slight drop in house shows.
Stop doing house shows. You're drawing 70 people at a fucking baseball stadium.
I would stop. I would stop for a good year minimum doing house shows. They may actually do it, but I mean, they do TV tapings. That's all they should be doing. I don't care if they tape a fucking year in advance. I don't really give a shit, to be honest with you.
I care, dude. It's pretty bad.
Well, I don't. It doesn't even matter to me anymore. I just want to see fucking wrestling on my
taste away from the excitement, man. If you know this guy, I mean, come on, man. Bound for Glory, that pay-per-view was ruined because of this shit. Because they fucked up and they basically changed all the titles 2 months prior to the fucking pay-per-view, and they had to replace all the guys with basically like jobbers against Japanese guys.
No, and then last night they changed a couple of titles.
Did they?
They did. They changed the Knockouts title, and the X Division title was vacated by Samoa Joe and picked up by Loki. So, and Taryn Terrell got the Knockouts title. God, she has a great set of tits. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, she does. So, isn't Samoa Joe injured?
I think so. I think that's why they had to do what they did. They vacated the title, but
yeah.
I thought it was odd on your technically last show on Spike, you changed titles, but also it's going to give them a good place to start when they go to a new network. So, we'll see what happens, man. I mean, I'm definitely glad they got another TV deal, that they're not going to die right now.
They're going to take another 2 years to die a slow death.
Well, like I said, I'm not going to be a complete optimistic and say, oh, they're going to be better than ever. I'm hoping they'll, you know, get this. And, you know, someone in the chat room saying Spike was everywhere. Not really. You actually have to pay for digital to get Spike. So not everyone pays it, not everyone gets Spike. So that was, you know, that's probably one of their other problems is, I don't know. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. I hope they do good. I hope they
Yeah, I think you locked up on it for 3 minutes.
Oh, sorry. I was just saying I hope they're doing good, and I hope they can keep up the same pace as they have been with the great shows they've been putting on TNA. We'll see, I guess.
Yeah. The shows that I watched from New York, man, I mean, they were certainly great shows. I mean, I can't deny that. I just, it's hard to get invested in TNA. But I don't know, man. Hopefully it'll get better.
I hope so, and I hope, you know, now that all this, oh, they're dead, they have no TV going, that, you know, I see, and I don't know, man, I think some of the stuff with taking some of the titles off of people is contract issues. You know, you got Havoc, who might not have been under a full contract, because she just got there.
Right.
Excuse me. They may be worried about Bobby Lashley and doing MMA that he may not have signed for a long time. That might be why they took the title off of him. And, you know, Samoa Joe, he's hurt, so I'm not going to bring up that title, but I think that might be why they took the title off of some of those guys the way they did, because of contract and not knowing what they're doing.
Yeah, but the rest of them are still just awful.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm just giving the couple that I can see where it might be a problem. Those two titles I can see with, like I said, Lashley and the other one, so.
Yeah. Well, we also have a Bad News Barrett. He's gonna be returning next month. So.
Nice.
I don't know if he's gonna get a push. I don't know if he's still gonna be over. But I don't know, man. I mean, the roster can certainly use some new guys again. I mean, not necessarily new, but some guys returning. So I'm not complaining.
No, and you know he had some good momentum before he got hurt.
Yeah.
So yeah,
this has been a bad year, man. I mean, for wrestlers, look at Daniel Bryan. Look what happened to Daniel Bryan. He had the biggest moment of his life, and then he just got completely just screwed. I mean, look at Bad News Barrett. You know, he was, as soon as he got over, he got injured. Look at Roman Reigns. He was about to get the push of his life, got injured. So.
Yeah, it has been kind of a strange year for the wrestling.
CM Punk walks out, turns to Phil Brooks.
Yeah, nice. Awesome.
Now, I guess they are going to be called A New Day. That's the actual name. My God. So they're going to be debuting this Sunday at Survivor Series for anybody that may give a shit. Yeah, and New Day, hopefully, those days won't last too long.
I don't know, man. I'm curious, again, I'm curious to see what's how they're going to come out, what's going to happen, but I don't know.
Now, the only way I can see them saving this is if they come out and they do like a heel turn. If they're coming out as preachers, as random black preachers, just doing the stereotypical, you know, fucking dancing around and all this shit, that's not gonna get over as a face gimmick. I mean, what do they expect from the fans to do? Are they gonna like dance around with them, or I don't get it.
I don't know. Like I said, I'm just curious to see what they're gonna do with them, and then I'll probably be done with it after that.
I mean, if they do a heel turn, man, I think it might work. They need some more faces, but at the same time, they need to get rid of some of the old faces. Because, I mean, Kofi's been a face for the longest time. He needs to turn heel. Sheamus needs to turn heel. Xavier Woods, I mean, who gives a shit? Big E, I don't know. I'm sure they can do something with the guy, but. I don't think this whole preacher thing is going to be. I mean, this is going to be the death for them. You know?
I know. I know. But I don't know, man. Whatever.
Also, the Hall of Fame. I guess Macho Man and Sting are rumored to be going in this year. So that's pretty good.
Oh, Sting, I definitely. I mean, that was a given since, like, the day they brought him in, I knew that was going to happen.
But Macho Man, that's awesome, man. One of the guys that I definitely rooting for.
Yeah, I kind of wish they had done it without all the, what can I say here, without all the media scrutiny on him.
Yeah. But.
Or internet scrutiny, about the internet always saying, you know, why the fuck haven't you done it yet? But I guess better late than never, right?
Well,
I mean, it's so. just a WWE Hall of Fame. It's not like it's a real Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
He's Hall of Fame in my book.
I mean, Coco Beware is in the Hall of Fame, so.
Drew Carey.
It is. Yeah, oh, God, please stop. Stop
Pete
it.
Rose.
Stop it.
Dude, Jerry Springer's next.
Oh, my God.
I'm telling you.
They gotta stop doing this shit, man. They gotta stop putting these pointless people in there. I mean, Donald Trump was fine. I mean, Mr. T, absolutely fine. Those guys were fine. But, I mean, Jerry Springer and all these other guys, man, they have to stop doing this. And I get it. I know why they do it. It makes sense, I guess, from a business standpoint. Then again, I don't. It hurts my eyeballs to watch it.
Your show.
You know? But, let me see over here.
Man. God damn that internet locking up. Anyway, I got you back now.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to happen. There's nothing we can do about it. That's what I was saying. Hopefully, next week we're going to try this without the actual stream. We're going to try this just. We're going to see how it works like that. I might not lock up as much.
There you go.
We
already talked about TNA. We pretty much talked about everything except for Raw and Survivor Series. So we're already halfway into Raw, so might as well just talk about that.
That's what I was about to pull up. The Survivor Series match card.
Well, let's go over Raw and get that out the way so we can be fair.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get it pulled up.
Fucking WWE, man. Too much television. Jesus.
That's why I'm down to watching Raw. Only Raw.
Yeah, I there's no way I can watch SmackDown ever, man. There's no way. NXT and stuff, I can't watch it. Too much.
Yeah, I can't do NXT. I tried, and I've tried again, and I've tried again. I can't
even watch TNA, man. That's why I can't watch ROH. That's why I can't watch TNA. It's too much, man.
Yeah. I like watching TNA.
Honestly, I mean, I like it too. It's just like, I don't know, man. I watch it religiously for a couple months, and then I just kind of tune out, and I just stop, and I tune back in. I don't know. Same with, like, ROH. If they were on television, I'd probably watch it every week. Right now, I'll watch a couple episodes, a couple weeks, and then I'll just stop for a couple months, and I don't know. Kind of hard to keep up with it.
Yeah, it is. Oh, there you go. Body has a point. Grumpy Cat for Hall of Fame. Next few years, Grumpy Cat is in.
That's better than Drew Carey.
No.
Man, put that cat in for Drew Carey.
Drew Carey can at least speak. This cat just falls asleep during Raw.
That's better. That's better.
You're right. You know what? You're right. The cat tells the truth.
Yeah, just bring that cat out. Let, you know, we don't need the talking. Imagine if they bring Jerry Springer. He's going to come out there and give a 25-minute speech. No one's trying to hear that shit, man. Bring that out. It'll be silence for a minute. We'll get it over with. It's painless. It's short. Straight to the point. We know it's bullshit. You have to put some corny fucking TV star in the Hall of Fame. Okay, put the cat in. We're done. There you go. So, Body, thank you. You're welcome, WWE. There you go. Credit to Bod.
There you go.
Hall of Fame.
Good job. So, I guess we should get back into Raw.
I guess, man.
I don't know why I love this so much, but I do.
Fantastic.
Okay. Let's see here. I'm just pulling up. I just got the match result. The
I think it was Dolph Ziggler versus Luke Harper for the Intercontinental title.
Yes.
This was a good match.
It was a good match, and it was a little odd.
Very odd.
Okay, good. I'm glad I'm not the only one.
It was very odd. It was just, you know, on-the-spot match for the title. Of course, we had the title changed hands, and the match was very short. I did appreciate the fact that they didn't just have Dolph Ziggler pretty much just get killed out there by Luke Harper. They actually had some kind of interference prior to the match starting. And at the same time, Luke Harper didn't look bad. He looked like he could actually kill Dolph Ziggler, but they didn't have him actually kill Dolph Ziggler, which is good. So hopefully they'll save it for a pay-per-view, the rematch. Or maybe they won't. Maybe we'll get it on Raw.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely liked the match. I was a little weirded out by the title change, you know, the week, you know, on the go-home show to Survivor Series, but whatever.
Do you think they're trying to add prestige to the Intercontinental title? It seems like they're trying.
By putting the belt on a dirty guy?
It doesn't matter if he's dirty, man. I mean, he's a fucking beast.
Yeah.
You standing next to Rusev and the rest of these guys, man, he towers over everybody.
Yeah, yeah. He's definitely better in the ring than I mean, he's the standout of those three, most definitely, in my opinion, you know. So, I don't know.
What three?
Bray.
Who?
Bray.
Who?
Him and, oh, right. Where the fuck has he been?
I don't even know who he is.
He's making these little promos and making chairs rock.
Yeah.
The guy that makes chairs rock when he gets up.
I bet you he had a hell of a time on Halloween.
Oh, yeah. He probably just went out as himself.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was actually a lot of people dressed up as... I saw a ton of people dressed up as Bray Wyatt on Facebook.
Oh, yeah. There was a lot of people.
There was a lot of people.
Let me share this on... Take over for 1 second. I'm going to share this on our Twitter so we can... get the word out on the show while we're going live.
There you go. Well, I'll just go into the next match because I know you don't want to talk about it. Tyson Kidd and Adam Rose. Yeah. Tyson Kidd actually won a match on Raw. So I don't know what to even say about that.
he's actually been winning a lot. He's on like a streak.
I'll say this 1,000 times. I don't care how much shit I get for it. I think Tyson Kidd is damn good. I personally would throw him in a fucking mask because I think he looks like a fucking troll. But I think the guy is good.
Yeah, but if you throw him in a mask, you might as well, you know, ship him off to Lucha Underground.
Or keep him and maybe do something different.
Yeah, but they won't, so they might as well just ship out Underground where they get better matches out of them.
They probably would. And you know what? I'll tell you right now, if this Lucha Underground takes off, I wouldn't doubt if you started seeing some of the guys going over there.
Yeah. I mean,
I don't know, man. I'm hoping it takes off because, I mean, I'm loving it. I really hope it doesn't get pulled or end or anything because...
Well, I think they're getting a lot of viewers on the Encore because it plays on I think on Univision. I think it's like a Spanish channel.
Yeah, here it plays on I think it might be Telemundo here.
Yeah, it is.
Sorry, it does replay this channel, but I'd obviously prefer the English commentary.
Yeah, I can't get it either way, so.
Yeah, the Spanish channel does carry it here, but I wouldn't want to listen to it unless I'm getting English commentary. Maybe that is with English commentary. I should check it out, I guess.
There you go, man. No, it's actually not with English commentary.
Well, then I'll just do what I'm doing and obtain it my way.
Yeah, it's Vampiro and somebody else doing the Spanish commentary.
Oh, really? Vampiro's still doing the Spanish commentary? Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
I wonder who he's doing it with. I don't know. I'm not going to look it up. I don't care.
Jim Ross is doing a story for Fox Sports on draws. He just tweeted it out that he had a great interview with draws today, which I'm excited for, man. I mean, no one's really heard from draws in fucking years.
Dude, I remember watching that show where he got paralyzed.
You've seen it? I thought it was like a house show.
No, it was right on. It was on Raw.
Really?
It was right on television where D'Lo put him through the announce table. And he didn't know.
I don't know. I always thought it was on a house show. I always thought there was no footage of it.
No, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure it was on that Raw.
If anybody in the chat room knows anything about this.
YouTube, quick too.
Yeah. But, what the hell? Anyway. Yeah, back to Raw, man. So we got Adam Rose and we got... to some folks, I guess. Not necessarily me. But, yeah, the bunny was doing some humping in the ring, and then he started air humping on the ramp. I don't know. What do you think about this, man?
I thought it was absolutely ridiculous. I thought it was awkward. But you know what? You're right. There is no footage.
Yeah, it was at a house show.
You're right. I could have swore it wasn't, but looks like you're right. Let me see here.
There you go, man. We are professional spitting facts on the podcast.
No, we just have computers.
Hey, man, I spit facts over here, dude.
We have the Google. The Google helps us spit facts to you people.
I am a fact-spitting machine.
That's right. We are fact spitters.
Exactly. That's why I tell you folks that Vince Russo's with the WWE.
That's right.
Facts.
Fact.
Again. Spitting facts tonight. That should be the... Spitting facts. Hashtag spitting facts. Yeah. But yeah, Raw. Yeah, that happened. The bunny humped Adam Rose, and Adam Rose is slowly turning heel, which I think may help him because he certainly is not entertaining as a face, so I don't know.
I don't know. Meanwhile in the chat room, Draz's active wrestling career ended suddenly when he suffered a severe neck injury during a match with D'Lo Brown during a WWF SmackDown taping on October 5th, 1999. So figure that never got put in to the actual show. So again from Body, spitting facts back at us.
Hashtag facts, man. God damn, Body. He's a wrestling... encyclopedia, man.
Just oh, no, by the way, he says, so says Wiki for what it's worth, so.
Okay. Well, Wiki's always spitting facts.
I shouldn't have said that. I should just let everyone think Body was a genius, which he is, obviously.
And, you know, that's why Wikipedia is wonderful, man. Anybody can just go on Wikipedia and just edit it and just start spitting out some facts.
Yeah, I know. Have you ever gone on Triple H's? Like, right after a Raw?
No, but I'm sure there's a lot of facts being spit out.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. You locked up for a second. We're back.
No big deal. Yeah, you did too, so who cares. But, anyway, back to the whole bunny. Are we still on the bunny match?
No, let's go to the next one, please.
Perfect, thank you, because it was creepy and awkward. Anyway, Ryback Cesaro.
Hold on one second. How do you explain that to your kids, though, honestly? If you take your, I mean, you're a father, I'm not. If you take your kid to a live event, and you have this bunny start humping this grown-ass man in the middle of the ring, what do you say to your kid?
I'm not quite sure how I would explain it. Maybe I would tell him it was some sort of call.
Some sort of bunny call?
I don't know. I don't know. I hate lying to my kids. I like to try to come up with something at least 90% truthful and just kind of make it sound better than it is.
That's why it's awkward, man. That's why it's awkward.
Yeah, that is. It is. It was just completely weird. I don't know how I would explain that to my kid, except tell him bunnies make a lot of babies, and that's how they do it. That's probably where I would say.
Yeah. So that'll terrify them, and they'll hate Easter.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Thank you, WWE. Next match, please. Jesus. Ryback and Cesaro. Ryback is fucking over. Jesus. Guy's over.
Yeah, I agree. I think he is too, man. The crowd's loving him right now.
Yeah, it was really funny watching Cesaro, you know, wrestle circles around this guy, though. It honestly reminded me of Bill Goldberg and Steven Regal in WCW when Steven Regal got fired.
I mean,
he had him blown up, man.
Yeah, it was, you're right, Cesaro did wrestle fucking circles around this guy, but Ryback, I'll say he held his own.
Yeah, but he looked like he wanted to puke by the end of the match, man. He looked fucked up.
He probably did. He looks like he wants to puke at the end of his little matches half the time.
True.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm surprised Meltzer didn't report, rumors of Ryback almost having a heart attack. That's pretty much what they did with Brock Lesnar. He looked tired after the match with Cena. Oh, my God, he almost had a heart attack. Let's report this and make up some more lies.
Well, like when Big Show was in the Accolade, they started reporting that he's probably sick because of how red his head turned.
Yeah. They honestly, I mean, where did they come up with this shit, man? I mean...
Dude, sometimes I think Meltzer just smokes some pot, thinks up some things, and writes it down.
Probably. I mean...
I could come up with some crazy shit when I'm high. I just need to write it down.
Probably what he does. I mean, he makes up half of the shit, so...
And then he gets busted on it and never apologizes. Or never, you know, he'll do like a, oh, correction. But he won't be like, I fucked up.
I love how he just like reports, like, you know, just really just stuff that's not even newsworthy, you know, just common sense stuff that you would pick up just watching the television, like you know, fucking, I don't know, I can't think of an example, but he reports some of his reports are just fucking ridiculous, man.
Yeah, but everybody picks them up and puts them on their website and. Does what they do.
That's got to be a weird career, though, just making up wrestling lies for the last, like, 35 years.
You know, and I don't know if the guy makes up lies or if someone in WWE leaks, and I'm doing air quotes, leaks stuff to him purposely.
Well, if he's leaking stuff to him, he's leaking lies. That would be more of a rib.
Right, but I could see WWE, I don't know, I could see him meeting in a back room on a conference call. Hey, Dave, guess what we got for you today, hey?
Showing up in a shady alley.
Yeah, in a shady alley, talking like they're in the 40s. Meh, guess what I got for you today, Dave? Meh, see? Magical listen world, see? And you are going to say... What I want you to say, man.
Dave Meltzer should do that on his podcast. Just before
a whole sentence.
Man.
We're going to do a whole show like that here. Man.
Man.
That's right. Muggsy, I ain't letting no coppers in here.
The Wrestling Observer. Man. Good stuff, man. They should do that. So this time, you're welcome, Dave Meltzer.
Man, I should be getting paid millions for my voice work, I swear.
There you go, man. Make it happen.
I should be, man. I should be doing Scooby-Doo.
There you go, man. Contact WWE. They fucking love Scooby-Doo.
Oh, man, I could have been the voice of Scooby-Doo. Oh, it's John Cena.
Maybe they would have brought you out in the Scooby-Doo costume.
Ron Reno.
Man, you gotta do some voice drops for the show, man.
I've done a couple of... I actually did some for Jack, but he didn't use them. No, he did. He used a few of them.
Yeah.
He did use a few of them. If you ever saw the, what was that one he did with the, Master of Grayskull?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay. That was me at the beginning. That was my, I was doing the wizard voice, the evil, gnarly wizard voice.
Yeah, man. Do some drops and shit so we can, plug them in between the...
Yeah, I probably should. Get myself a demo reel and start making some fucking real money around this. Make some money in this bitch. Up in this mug.
Up in this motherfucker.
I do a horrible Stone Cold though, so whatever. But
up in this motherfucker.
Hell yeah. So yeah. But
what was the next match?
It was the Rusev Heath Slater thing.
Oh.
I have never laughed so much as when Heath Slater walked out there the other night.
Man, he looked like an idiot.
He did, but I couldn't stop laughing at his dumb ass because he made the gimmick great.
Dude, he wasn't even over in Virginia, his home state. You didn't even hear him there.
I don't know, man. I like the guy. And I'll tell you what, there's another guy I could see in a mask.
Yeah. He's probably better off in a mask.
Yeah, there's another guy I could see in a mask, probably getting over like a motherfucker too, but I don't know. I'm just a silly wrestling fan. What do I know?
Yeah, man. Oh,
God, we have microphones. We're awesome.
There you go, man. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, man.
Yeah.
Nothing really excited me. I mean, it wasn't really a bad show. I wouldn't say it was a bad show.
No.
That Cesaro and Ryback match was pretty good.
What did you think?
Ziggler and Harper was pretty good.
Yeah, it was, but you didn't tell me what you thought of Lana's topless picture.
Oh, Vladimir Putin. It was funny that they even had her go out there and you know, make mention of anything in regards of being topless, because she's actually done topless photos, so that was kind of weird.
Yes, we were actually looking at him in the chat room right as she was talking about it.
Nice.
Yes.
Honestly, is it just me, or are they actually trying to be a little bit more edgy? Just because of these type of things that they do, and the, you know, as stupid as it is, the bunny humping Adam Rose, I mean, all that stuff, it's not edgy in a good way, but it's edgy nonetheless.
I think they're trying to push the envelope as close as they can without getting in trouble, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that's how I would say it. I don't know. I mean, I definitely see that they're doing a little bit of edgy pushing, but it's edgy with little kids' characters. You know?
Yeah. Which
really
makes it awkward, you know?
Yeah, but I mean, you know, like I said, Lana's not a kid's character, but it definitely came off a little creepy, but I don't know, man. I definitely see him pushing, but they've done this before. They'll push a little bit, and then Glad or someone will chime in with something they said wrong, and then they'll back off, and you get shitty programming for another 2 months.
Yeah, and then you're going to get Rusev coming out of character, and he's going to introduce himself to be like, you know, John Smith, and he's going to basically tell everybody that this is a gimmick, and
You know, I was born in America, and, you know, basically what Jack Swagger and fucking Zeb Coulter did.
Yeah. Was Rusev born in America?
Probably not, but I don't know. Doesn't matter. Give a shit.
Now you got me wondering.
I don't think he was. He, I mean, he has the Bulgarian flag tattooed on his arm.
Yeah.
I'm guessing he's got some deep roots in his culture. I don't know.
I don't know. Or he could just... I don't know. Who knows? Nope, he is Bulgarian because I cannot pronounce his fucking name.
Nice.
Miroslav Barmyashev.
Miroslav Barmyashev.
Good, yeah. No, Yashev. Yashev? Yashev? You could probably say this name better than me.
Yeah, I don't know. Are Bulgarians, like, do they have ties with Russians?
I don't know, but he was born in Bulgaria.
Oh, okay.
Yes, he was, and didn't come here till the mid-2000s, so... And in 2010, got himself a contract in WWE.
Nice. Well, see, that explains it, man. That explains why this gimmick kind of actually works, because it's...
him.
Real. You know?
Yeah, it's him.
Good. I really like Rusev, man, like I said last week. I think he's actually decent in the ring. I don't really mind him. And I think Lana's great. I think she definitely adds to his character and adds depth.
That's right. Once again, we are... spitting facts at you.
Yes, sir. Spitting facts.
That's right.
Spitting out facts, dude. Bruh.
There you go.
What else on this wonderful episode of Raw?
Yeah, let's get through this fucking episode of Raw so we can go on other shit.
Yeah, we still got House of Hardcore and Survivor Series.
Oh, damn. Wow.
Yeah, let's run through Raw. What the fuck happened in Raw? What happened? Tell me.
What else happened? What else happened? Oh, dude. Big Show was out there.
Oh, God, don't remind me.
Big Show versus Sheamus.
Why was he crying again? It looked like he was crying again, dude.
He was crying like a pussy.
He was crying like a pussy.
He was crying like a pussy.
I know you like that one.
Yeah, he was crying like a pussy.
I'm glad I stole that from Trading Places. it was like the first time I saw Big Show crying, I thought about that clip, and I'm like, I have got to get that.
Dude, he cries way too much. I mean, he was damn near in tears because he had to face Sheamus. Okay, I get it. You guys are tag team partners for John Cena's team, but you guys don't really have any prior ties. You guys weren't tag teams together. You're not friendly with each other. I mean, who cares? You know? That's just lack of common sense and storytelling, but what do I know?
I don't know. You're just a guy on a podcast like me.
I am just a guy on a podcast.
That's it. We're just talking shit on YouTube, my friend.
There we go.
That's all we're doing. That's it. Anyway, Big Show versus Sheamus.
That's how I pick up women, man. I just tell them I do a show on YouTube, and they're like, oh, really? Yeah. What I do, man, podcast, well, I talk about wrestling, and then as soon as I say that, they leave.
They leave. Just tell them you do a caller-driven...
Yeah, I got a lot of
caller-driven podcast where the callers make up the topics.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's kind of what I'd like to do. But anyway...
just any other podcast other than wrestling would probably work. wrestling. Oh, like the fake, like, fighting?
Yeah, people really...
Kind of.
Get into the whole thing. A lot of times I'll just be like, do you like magicians? And like almost everyone says, yeah, I love magicians. And then you go, okay, does he really make the girl disappear? And they give me that.
Well, I mean, it just.
Well, yeah, they usually give me that. You can apply that. What?
I mean, you can apply that to anything, man. Movies, it's all the same shit.
Exactly. It's like, I hate all this repetitive. Well, if you can watch a movie more than twice, shut up.
Yeah. Well, like The Walking Dead. I mean, I don't personally watch it. I know it's a big thing. Or Breaking Bad. I mean, those guys weren't really selling heroin or meth or whatever the fuck they were selling. It's not real. It's still entertaining. But you have to keep watching it.
But you can buy a Breaking Bad toy now with meth.
Awesome. That's wonderful for the kids. So.
Isn't that great? Look, son, I got you toy meth.
Yeah, so I'm excited to see all these kids grow up. That's great. So we're gonna get a bunch of psychopaths and meth users in the future generations. So wonderful. Thank you, Breaking Bad. Great. You've shat on the world.
Wonderful.
Thanks.
Yeah, and I'm a horrible person for letting my son watch wrestling, and you're bringing home Breaking Bad meth dolls to your kids.
Thanks. So I'll have 14-year-old meth users trying to make attempts to rob me in like 20 years. It's great.
You know, just so everyone knows, if you're in our chat room right now, which I know not many of you are, but there's a few people in there, they're posting some pictures of... Some of the pictures of when Draws did get hurt.
Oh man, somebody posted on the Facebook.
Really? Might be the same person.
No, I'm asking somebody to.
Oh, well, hold on a minute. I can post them.
There you go.
I'll pull them up.
Sure.
I thought you said someone did. I'm like, oh, wait a minute.
I'm asking somebody to do it.
I'll pull them up right here. Give me 1 minute. 1 minute. Let me see if it'll do. Uh-oh, I cannot right-click.
Take a screen capture.
I can do one better. View page source. Find the JPG.
There you go.
Got it.
See how professional we are? Yeah, we know how to do it all. We know how to save pictures from chat rooms. I mean, who do you know that can do that?
Fucking
the Hot Tag Podcast. That's who.
That's it. The one and only things.
We do it all. We save JPEGs. We save. Yeah. By the way, are they called GIFs? GIFs? How do you pronounce it?
I call them GIF.
Yeah, I've always wondered that. GIF. GIF. Sure. What are they?
I call them GIFs. I don't know if they have an actual name, but.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're capable of all that. So you should listen to it. We're that professional.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the actual JPEG file right now. This has some. Right now, I'm kind of on the. This is just the actual. Well, you know what? You can look at the pictures yourself.
All right.
Here you go. I'm hitting post right now.
I can do that. I do have eyes.
There you go. That was actually the pic I was looking at just a minute ago. And that's that's body in the room.
Yeah, I see it now.
And he's right. Learning how to save those porn pics is starting to pay off. That's how I knew to do that. You're right.
Man.
Yeah, porn pic, see? You never get me alive, coppers. Never.
It's just that one picture, right?
No, actually there's one... Hold on. There's like four.
Okay.
Here, I'll post the rest in the comments. I can post some more in the comments.
All right, let's finish this goddamn episode of Raw.
Dude, so much more better stuff to talk about.
Yeah, all right, let's go over the basic, you know, the big moments. Basically...
I mean, this was a go-home show for Raw, and it did not seem like it, but anyway.
I mean, I'm kind of excited for the main event for the pay-per-view.
I guess.
I think the heel team is definitely a good team.
I think the main event for the pay-per-view is going to be good. But you know what? Let's get through Raw so we can get into the pay-per-view, because I got the whole match card pulled up here.
All right.
Let's get through. Hold on. I've got one more picture to post in the comments, and there's all four of them that they were showing. There you go. There's all four that we've seen in the chat room. So there you go. You could have just come in the fucking chat room, you know.
Yeah, I know. I hate chat rooms, dude. I have something against chat rooms. I don't know why.
There's going to be one slap in the on the side of our YouTube soon, so.
There, yeah. Well, I mean, I can do that. I just hate, like, multitasking while I'm podcasting.
I got two computers going here, so I know what you're talking about.
There you go.
Yeah, so.
Pictures now. That's a shame.
Yeah, horrible. I mean, and you know what? If you look, I mean, you can look at the pictures and tell he ain't getting up. And you can see how his legs are just limp. So.
Not good.
And I really I liked him, man. I really did like Draws. I really thought he was a good character. He was awesome.
He's gonna puke.
Yeah, I remember watching that on Beyond the Mat.
Vince McMahon is an asshole.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Pretty much. Well, here's, you know what? I think we're almost done. We only got two matches left.
All right, let's do it. What's next?
And then, we talked a little bit about the contract signing, so we'll just breeze over it. And this match, you're not even going to care to talk about. Brie versus Nikki. Brie was just dressed up as AJ. And AJ was on commentary. And Brie won on to the next match.
Thank you.
On to the, I guess this match would be considered the main event, right?
I think so, I guess.
Well, kind of the contract signing was your main event, so we'll roll this all into one and... Hit the button. Last match. There you go. Goldust, Stardust, The Miz, and Damian Sandow against Los Matadores and The Usos. Let that sink in.
Which was weird. They pretty much just gave away the match.
They completely gave away the match. Anyway, the heels won. it was a good match. The tag team matches have all been pretty good lately, but I don't know. It just seemed like filler until they could get to the contract signing for me.
Yeah, they should have They should have just saved it for the pay-per-view.
Yeah, I would have rather have seen these guys in a contract signing than what we saw.
Nah, I don't know, man. I didn't really mind it.
No, I guess it wasn't horrible, but
I actually kind of liked it.
The contract signing?
Yeah.
I didn't think it was horrible. I really thought Cena kind of ruined it, but...
Well, he always does, man. What's new?
Yeah. Yeah, and, I mean, if you didn't see the Ryback double turn that night happening, then you're probably 8 years old.
Probably.
Yeah. The Authority had a contract signing for this main event or Survivor Series. Cena showed up by himself, and I'm sure everyone thought, oh, Cena's going to waste everybody. And next thing you know, the music hits, and Dolph Ziggler comes down, Big Show comes down, Eric Rowan comes down.
Which was really random. Just out of nowhere.
It was random. It was surprising. I'm not going to lie. It was surprising. I do like this. But it was very... It's like you're going to waste this whole feud with these two in a match with a bunch of other people?
And also, I mean, Eric Rowan as a face, wasn't he just like being like a kind of like a perverted stalker a minute ago?
He was basically Sam Shaw with a beard.
Right, and a mask.
Which, I don't know, maybe someone listened and stopped what they were doing.
Maybe.
I said it last week. Just stop. Stop. Stop what you're doing.
Stop it.
Stop it. So maybe someone listened.
Well, can I go ahead and question WWE for a minute?
Of course.
I know this is going to go ahead and, you know, people are going to say, I'm complaining and whatever. I don't care, dude. Fuck off. We're going to state our opinions. John Cena.
I'm sitting back for this one.
This fucking guy. Now, the whole team pretty much got decimated earlier, right? They got completely just demolished.
Yep.
Couldn't come back. Where the fuck was John Cena? Where was he?
He was. They established where he was. He was watching it on the monitor.
Exactly. So why are these guys coming to his aid? Why are they trying to help him out? It doesn't make sense, man.
Because it was in the script?
Yeah. Well, the script doesn't make sense. Sorry. Not convenient. This is just basic storytelling. You know, you're partners with the guy. You're getting the shit kicked out of you. You would think the guy would come and help you. But no. But then when he goes out there, then everybody else comes out to help him. Man, fuck this guy.
I know, man. I thought it was pretty odd, too, that, you know, those two were out there getting their asses kicked, and Cena's just back there. And they had shown him literally less than 5 minutes ago watching the match. I really figured they were going to show him watching the match so he would know what was going on. And even the crowd was chanting Cena's name if you missed it.
I did miss it, and I'm glad enough of the crowds cheering this guy. I mean, San Antonio was bad enough.
Yep, they were, but I mean, they wanted him to come out and help, and he was. Maybe he was eating a burrito or something. I don't
know. Yeah, well, I hope his excuse is banging Nikki backstage. It's probably the only excuse that
would that'd be mine. That would be mine. I'd be like, man, she came back from that match all sweaty and sexy. I just had a banger.
There you go, man. Makes sense. You know?
But that was it.
But another thing that I have to go ahead and question, when Cena comes out by himself and there's about 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9 or 20 heels in the ring, why don't they just take advantage of that opportunity and just beat the shit out of the guy?
Why is he the... Okay, I'm going to go even further. Why is he really the only one they haven't beat the hell out of?
Because he's Super Cena.
Okay, but they beat the hell out of Big Show, who's bigger and stronger than John Cena.
But he cries, and he wears diapers.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot.
You was crying like a pussy.
Crying like a pussy.
You love that one.
I do love that one.
Oh, I'm glad.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know, man. Cena, I don't know.
It just doesn't make sense, man. I mean, if there's all these heels in the ring that want to kill this guy, well, there's your perfect opportunity. He's by himself. You got about 10 guys in the ring. Okay, there you go. Beat him up.
They book him like he's goddamn Rocky V or something. I don't know.
Even worse, man. He's fucking, I don't know. John Cena is like the second coming of Jesus.
Rocky V.
One more round.
I loved Rocky V. I got a couple of them from there.
That was cool.
The best line from Rocky V. You ready?
I am.
You knocked him down. Why don't you try knocking me down?
Yeah, you knocked him down. Why don't you try knocking me down?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Well, that was Raw, folks. So we got the Survivor Series match built up, and I'm gonna go ahead and drop some spoilers.
Oh wait, one quick thing before we end Raw.
All right.
Strap in, ladies and gentlemen. Your guest host next week, Larry the Cable Guy.
No comment.
I need a cricket sound.
Yeah, you do. Cause
I need, hold on. Let me see. I really need a cricket sound for that, because that was just...
Hey, they have to, they, why do they do this to people, man? Why do you hate us, WWE? Why are you trying to torture me? Crickets.
Are they hanging me? Why? Do you know? Do you know?
Please enlighten me.
Okay.
I don't. Please enlighten me.
It is...
I am here.
Jingle All the Way 2, starring Larry the Cable Guy and Santino. So having him in there is basically a promotion for the movie.
All right. That's awesome.
So...
Oh, that's exciting. There you go, folks. Give me back the cat, man. Bring that cat in every week. Much better than the rest of that. By the way, can we talk about the cat for a minute, since we didn't talk about him at all? Or
Man, I'll tell you what, though. As soon as I said that about Larry the Cable Guy, I got one thing from you.
What's that? There you go. Crickets.
YouTube.
There you go.
I'll copy that and steal it.
There you go. We're Grand Theft Autoing this audio.
Hell yeah. So I'll get that tonight, have it in the old soundboard next week for us.
There you go, man. But yeah, the cat, man. How the hell did this cat just lay around for 3 hours of Raw?
Dude, that cat looked exactly how I look at about hour and a half in.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, literally, they do this close-up on the cat, and the cat's eyes are clearly not open.
Yeah, I felt bad for that cat, man.
I didn't feel bad for the cat. The cat was lying there sleeping, getting probably treated like a fucking king.
How can you not feel bad for that cat? He had to watch Raw for 3 hours.
Okay. I kind of
feel bad for myself for watching Raw for 3 hours and then coming on here and talking about it for another hour.
So, you only knew how many.
I feel your pain.
You know, and it's funny. This week I was doing the event thing on Facebook right during Raw, and you were hitting me up on the messenger on Facebook, and I was like, maybe I can just shut this off then and watch it like Wednesday night.
Yeah.
I was so close to just being like, you know what, I'll watch this later. But I didn't. I stuck through it. So, but yeah, I mean, I was really like there, like, man. And I'll say it again. If we did not have this goddamn podcast, I don't know if I'd be watching Raw right now. I would probably be taking a break.
It was a good time. I mean, I would probably tune back in right around Royal Rumble. It's a good time to tune back in.
Yeah. I mean, I'd probably still watch this pay-per-view because I mean, I've got the network. I'm not going to waste my money and cancel it. So I'd still watch this pay-per-view. I'd probably still watch the pay-per-views on networks and stuff, though. But I don't know, man. It's just getting so lazy.
Dude, the best way to watch Raw is to go on their YouTube, and they post, like, 30-second clips of each match. Best one. You watch the whole Raw within 10 minutes.
Dude, I think Tony was right. I might just start watching on Hulu. Your boy Tony, he might have been right. Just Hulu that shit.
Yeah.
I might.
Definitely not worth it. But, yeah, man. That was Raw.
Yeah. And like I said, Larry the Cable Guy. Oh, here's a picture with Paige and the Grumpy Cat.
Nice. Cesaro got a good one, too.
Yeah, how cute. God, Paige is hot.
Yes, she is.
God damn, she is.
Yes, she
up there's oh my God. There's a bunch of people with the cat.
Man, don't stain your pants now.
Oh, I'm the Why you gotta be like that, man?
Shut up! Gotta relax, man.
I just can't believe there's this many people with the cat.
Man, I just can't believe that I didn't realize I was doing a podcast with Jerry the King Lawler.
A new day. with the cat.
A new day with the cat. That is great.
Oh my God, kitties!
Oh, did you catch Jerry Lawler saying, "This week we got a cat and we got a bunny. Maybe next week we'll get puppies."
Yeah, I hear that. Grumpy cat sitting right against the ring and the turnbuckle. Oh, this is so cute.
Yeah, I like that cat, man.
Mizzed out with the cat. And then we get right into no more cat. Okay, I'm done.
Did you say you had the series card up?
I do. Let me close out Raw because we're done with that shit. And this is as of November 18th, so it's after Raw, so it should have everything we need. I think we've only got like 3 or 4 matches right now for Survivor Series, so look forward to some filler.
There's got to be a more updated one, because from my understanding, they added some matches on SmackDown. Let me go ahead and give this spoiler alert for SmackDown. So if you find folks don't want to listen to me talk about SmackDown, and you know you're not gonna watch it tomorrow. I know you're not, so give the shit. But there was a new stipulation added to the main event, which is basically if John Cena's team wins, you know, the Authority leaves, and if the Authority wins, John Cena's team is all fired, including John Cena.
I thought, didn't they mention that on Raw?
No, they added it on SmackDown.
I could have swore they mentioned something about that on Raw. Okay, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, but I don't know, man. And, you know, I heard Brian Alvarez basically say that they did this because Raw's been getting really poor ratings, like 3.0s and 2.8s and shit like that, and they wanted to add a new stipulation just to boost up the ratings for next week and get people excited for the pay-per-view. And then my question is, like, how are you boosting ratings when you do this on SmackDown? Nobody watches SmackDown. And second of all, it's not believable because, I mean, who really believes John Cena is getting fired?
I would love to believe it.
I would too.
But it ain't happening.
Nope, it is not. It certainly is not. Absolutely. But, that's that. But I'm expecting some big things at this pay-per-view, man, just because it's a free-for-all. So I'm really trying to impress people. So I don't know, man. They have to do something big. I'm not quite sure what it's going to be. But I don't know, man. I hope it's something good.
I don't know. I'm trying to pull up a couple right now that are from I pulled up whatever's in the last 24 hours. So just give me 1 minute for them to load.
Yeah, and I'm guessing Vince McMahon is going to be back because it's pretty obvious that the Authority is probably going to lose and Vince is going to come back and all that good. Which I wouldn't mind that, man. I wouldn't mind seeing Vinny McMahon back on my television.
Yeah, I got no problem with that.
Yeah, he's good. He can jump around, man. I'm fine with that.
All right. He can sit out there. All right. Let's see here. With only 3 matches in now. No, 4 matches were right, because the fourth match is... I'm looking here. With only 3 matches announced for the main event show prior to the start of Raw, WWE now has 6 matches booked. I'm sorry, you were right. WWE has 6 matches following the...
What happened, Fox, man? You keep questioning me, and I told you I'm a fact-spitting machine.
I know.
With heavy artillery, man. I'm sitting here just spitting facts.
I know.
Nothing but facts.
I know. Let's see here what we got. I'm trying to find just a list, but this is not a list.
We know for sure that we're going to have the Miz and Miz Dow against the Los Matadores, against...
Yeah, let's break out some of the guaranteed ones.
Yeah, against the Dust Brothers, and I'm guessing the Dust Brothers are probably going to win that one and retain the titles.
Probably are. I would hope they get that they do.
Yeah.
We got AJ Lee versus Nikki Bella.
Who gives a shit?
I like what Nikki comes to the ring in.
Yeah, she looks like a scumbag, though. She looks like her vagina stinks.
I would like to find out.
I would like to not smell her vagina. She looks good, man. I don't know about you. Our sister, you could tell she's probably, you know, taking care of herself a little bit better. She's probably drinking filtered water and eating mangoes and all that good shit.
Yeah, but she's like a hippie, so she probably smells.
I don't know, man. She probably detoxes a lot. Hippies are all about detoxing. You know?
Some of them, somehow. I don't know, man.
Yeah, I lost.
No, you didn't. I'm right here.
All right. Well, we also have Dean Ambrose against Bray Wyatt, which is...
Looking forward to it.
Yeah, but it's mind-boggling to me because it's like, all right, you're trying to build both of these guys up, so why would you put them against each other? Because obviously one guy has to lay down for the other guy. And the build-up to this match has been terrible. There's pretty much been no build-up. It's just been random promos and... I'm not too big on this. It seems like they always let me down with Bray Wyatt. Anything that has to do with Bray Wyatt, they always let me down.
And you know, when this whole thing happened at Hell in a Cell, I was like, God, yeah, you know, everybody was saying, oh, just think of how the promos are going to be amazing. Well, where are they?
Yeah.
Where are they?
Not on Raw. Not on Raw.
Yeah. Nope. I think I saw more on SmackDown. I think.
You may have.
But then again, I don't remember. I don't know. I go through SmackDown now when I do watch it in like 7-8 minutes.
The only way, man. I mean, who wants to watch 16 hours of WWE program in a week?
Yeah. I got up Saturday morning and watched SmackDown in, I think, 7 minutes. I was done with it in no time.
Yeah, I can't. I don't know. I blame you.
There was a time where I would get up and watch SmackDown, where I would watch SmackDown on Fridays, and my son would watch with me because SmackDown's, you know, obviously a little better for the kids, so I would let him watch that with me, and it's a Friday. But even he started just not even caring anymore.
Yeah, it's funny you mention that because there was also a time when I watched SmackDown, and that was in '99.
Wow. I mean, the beginning of this year, we were doing chat rooms for SmackDown. You know?
Why?
Because we'd have at least 5 or 6 people in there, you know, talking and just kind of, you know. But after a while, it just no chat room and people stop showing up. And I just figured, why bother watching, you know, live especially? So there were, I think I missed like 2 months of it, and then I figured I should at least start watching to see if I'm missing anything, and I'm not.
I mean, they can start doing some, you know, major angles on SmackDown if they want to gain some viewers, but they don't. So why would anybody watch it if it's just, you know, essentially just an encore of Raw, just rematches?
It's a recap, basically. It's a recap show. And it used to not be. It used to be its own show with its own storylines, and it was good.
Absolutely.
Think back when The Rock and, you know, all those people were on that show. It was awesome.
99, man. That's what I'm talking about.
Probably was 99. You're probably right. I
was 99.
I'm a couple of years, so.
Rock and Triple H, man. The very first SmackDown, 99.
Yeah, you're right.
Watch it on the UPN network.
Yeah, huh? I do remember that.
There you go.
I do remember. I was living in Florida. God, I wish I was back there.
But, yeah, man. We got the main event for Survivor Series. I guess that's the only one that's left. And
basically going to be Big Show, Dolph Ziggler, that Wyatt guy, John Cena.
Ziggler, Ryback.
Ryback. Against Luke Harper, Mark Henry, Rusev, Seth Rollins, and unfortunately, Corporate Kane.
I'm still a little shocked Triple H didn't insert himself in this match. I thought this would be a great opportunity for him to do it.
Definitely, yeah. It's definitely a questionable move.
And you know what? Come Sunday, it could still happen.
Maybe. Another thing that I didn't really understand was a match for a split second and the guy just left. It's like, what the fuck? Why? This guy, give him a push already, man. I mean, people have been waiting for this for like a year. I thought he was going to get a push after WrestleMania and he just got de-pushed and went down the drain pretty much. And now you have him stand next to Triple H and, you know, people are excited. Oh, he's going to actually get a push. He's going to be with the Authority. And nope. He just exits. He leaves.
Yeah.
Done. Finito. Finished. Gone.
I did like the little Cesaro fake out, though.
Yeah, but use him. He's not even on the card.
I know, but I thought the fake out was great. WWE actually fooled me for a minute. It was kind of funny.
Yeah, I didn't really get it because it was going to be like 6 against 5. So I don't know. Which I kind of wish they did that, because then they could actually have room for a surprise on at the show, which I'm guessing the surprise is going to be obviously Randy Orton. They're doing it in St. Louis, so it makes sense to do a full-fledged, you know, face turn in his hometown. So I get it, but I'm not really excited for a Randy Orton return. I mean, he's been gone for like 2 weeks. It's not really right.
They make it seem like they're gone for a year now, and it's 2 weeks.
Exactly. They make it seem like, you know, like Ultimate Warrior's coming back from the grave. No, it's Randy Orton. He was here 2 weeks ago.
Yep. You mean it's kind of like when Jericho was only out for 3 months and the crowd started chanting, "You still got it?"
Exactly. Yeah, he's still got it. Yeah, he's still got it.
You fucking dumb shits. He's been gone 3 months, you fucking sheep. Yep.
That's the same type of people that that were chanting "This is awesome" with like Miz matches against fucking Wade Barrett and all this shit. No, in fact, these are the same people that were chanting "This is awesome" when Stephanie and Brie Bella were facing off in the main event.
There you go.
That's always questionable. Like, yeah, we paid $500 for these front row seats to get, you know, Brie Bella against Stephanie McMahon facing off on a contract signing for the main event. This is awesome.
Yeah, always awesome. I'm sorry, I just swallowed the wrong way.
Oh, man, that didn't sound right.
I'm good. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm drinking ginger ale. Not like I'm drinking semen or anything. Jesus.
I know you're good. I don't know if I'm good after these comments. Jesus Christ.
I'm okay now.
Yeah, folks, what is this guy doing tonight, man?
I don't know what's going on with me, dude. Every time I fucking take a drink, my chest is killing me. I'm all right.
Yeah, man. Well, we're almost on like 3 hours of hot tagging. That's what you get.
Yeah, I know, man. Like I said, though, I've been busting my ass in the warehouse. My whole body is sore right now, so.
Yeah. I hear you, man.
Yeah, even our chat room, though, said they expected him to put himself in that match. It was like the perfect opportunity for Triple H to be, I mean, it was almost a self-written storyline.
Yeah, I mean, in storyline, his career is pretty much on the line.
Yeah, why wouldn't he want to, "I gotta do this myself, this is where I should be doing"? And like I said, it writes itself.
Yep, especially since he's a hands-on guy, you know, I mean, wouldn't you want to do it yourself?
You would think so, but I don't know. Body's got it. All the facts spitting, I forgot how to swallow.
Oh, man. Man.
Our chat room's on fire tonight. Thank God, because we're not.
Coming at your neck right there, man. Spitting these facts.
That's it, man. Spitting facts. I got to get a spitting sound effect, too.
There you go, man. We're some fact-spitting bastards.
That's it, man.
Yeah, we should change the podcast name to The Fact Spitters.
The Fact Spitters. The Fact Spitters.
Smoke weed every day.
Spitting facts every day.
I could probably do that.
But yeah, this was a Survivor Series preview for you guys. So I'm expecting Cena's team to win with the help of Randy Orton. And yeah, I'm expecting Vinnie McMahon to be back on my television pretty soon, which I'm excited for. So
yeah. Good. I would hope he's coming back, man. I'm not gonna say that, you know, oh, he's what's missing, but always likes Vince on TV. He's a character. He's a great character.
Yeah, he's definitely not what's missing, but at times like this where it's so boring, he can certainly help and be an addition to the show. So
I just hope he doesn't come back and start a feud with some guy and make it try to be like Stone Cold Vince McMahon again. Although,
yeah, it's Cesaro or somebody, man.
I could see him doing it with Ambrose. That would be fucking awesome, though.
That would be.
And he did go down there and shake Ambrose's hand. You could kind of...
Foreshadowing.
You could kind of... foreshadow, maybe... Man,
look at over here, huh? We're some geniuses.
We are. Those would be good fucking promos, man.
We are some geniuses over here. Spitting facts, dude.
Oh, man, I'm just thinking about those promos. That would be awesome, him and Vince. That would be fun. Who else you think right now could do that storyline with Vince? You said Cesaro. I agree.
No, I don't know if Cesaro could do it. I just wish, cause I mean, let's face it, Cesaro can't talk. I just wish Vince would kind of give him a rub and, co-sign him and give him a push, but I don't think the ideal feud would be, Cesaro and Vince. Ambrose is probably the closest one that would be able to pull it off.
Cena, man, he's the only one that can do it.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Cena. One Cena.
God, that would suck. Man, I could definitely see those two doing some great fucking work together, man. I don't know, but definitely would like to see Vince back on TV. I got no problem with that whatsoever.
John Cena's a wrestling god.
Ooh. Ooh, what's his name?
Did I just say that?
I think you did. What the hell happened?
I don't know, man. I'm a Cena fan now. He won me over. I'm a C Nation fan.
Wow. I'm just in shock right now.
Yeah, I can't even lie about that, man. That's how much I don't.
Like you
that.
Said it with a straight face.
Can't even lie. Anyway, do we have any other news or any WWE related stuff you want to talk about before I get into House of Hardcore?
No, dude. Go ahead and get right into House of Hardcore because you were there live.
I was live at the ECW Arena, which they have, they've done some, you know, they've reconstructed it, and it looks better, man. It's definitely stepped it up. So let me go ahead and actually pull this up, the results, because, my memory's kind of off and I don't remember what happened.
What was that, by the way? Because I want to pull them up and go with you here.
What was that?
What date was that?
I don't remember, but just put in House of Hardcore 7.
I just want to be able to look at them with you. It helps when I know sort of what you're talking about.
Only if I could find it.
I might just go on. Now, here we go. Right here on Ringside News has it. If you, I can post it on the Facebook if you want it.
Why don't you go ahead and just start it off, man. Just tell me what happened, and I'll kind of comment on it. Unless right. You post it off on the Facebook.
Here, I'll post it real quick.
All right.
Took me 5 seconds to do it, probably less than five. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 1,000, posted.
Damn. How professional are we tonight? God damn.
Hey, man. We got the fucking... We got computers.
We are damn good.
All right. There's the one I'm on, so we're on the same one.
House of Hardcore. All right.
Danny Doring?
Danny Doring, yes.
You're fucking kidding.
No, I'm dead serious. Stevie Richards came out, and he defeated Danny Doring in an okay match. I mean, Danny Doring, the last time I saw him at Extreme Rising, he kind of looked fat. And he still had some man boobs at this show, but much better than I expected. And then the next match, we got Team Tremendous and Little Guido, which they defeated Vic Dolly Shoes. Oh, who the fuck? Anthony Green and Ben Ortiz. And this match, I thought it was going to be terrible. Yo, and they stole this show. I don't know who these guys are. I'm pretty sure they're Tommy Dreamer's students, but they stole the show. When this comes out on DVD, definitely go on High Spots and purchase it. Fuck RF Video, but go on High Spots and purchase it. And, yeah, it's good stuff, man. But Eddie Edwards defeated Eddie Kingston. If anybody isn't familiar with Eddie Kingston, he's pretty big in Chikara. Eddie Edwards had to come out on his own because Davey Richards, I guess he was injured or something happened to him. But he was scheduled to appear, as well as EC3. EC3 was also injured, so he couldn't make the show. But he was also... Tony Nese defeated Alex Reynolds and Lance Anoya. And Lance is, I guess he's The Rock's niece or cousin or something. He's definitely related to the Usos. So, Tony Nese. What was that?
If he's a he can't be his niece because that would be a girl.
Whatever, man. I'm foreign. Give me a break.
I'm foreign? Since you're talking about Tony Nese, goddamn did TNA fuck up with that guy. He is awesome.
He's awesome, man. Tony Nese is one of the best independent wrestlers.
And TNA had him, and they let him go. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Yeah. A lot.
And yeah, I can tell that Lance Anoya, he's got, I mean, that's the last name right there, Anoya.
Yeah. So, I mean, he's not really good, though. I don't know. I don't really see much of the guy.
I'm sorry.
But, yeah, Tony Nese is awesome, man. Alex Reynolds, I don't know if you know him. He does a lot of PWS shows, CZW shows, Jersey All-Pro, all these types of shows in the East Coast. And he was actually trained by Mikey Whipwreck, him and his brother. So, really good match, man, really good match. And Tommy Dreamer typically books Tony Nese at every show in some kind of three-way with Alex Reynolds. One time he had a match with Petey Williams, actually in the first House of Hardcore, with Tony Nese, Petey Williams, and Alex Reynolds. Phenomenal match. I'd honestly give it like a 5 out of 5.
I love Petey Williams.
Yeah. But this match was all right. Tony Nese did all the usual high spots that he does. Alex Reynolds really just meshes well with him. And it was good stuff.
Cool.
The Dudleys made a surprise appearance, which, dude, the fucking roof went off this house. People went nuts. Just because, the Dudleys haven't been in the ECW arena in, probably 14 years. I don't think they've ever been back for any type of shows. So... Wow. People were definitely excited, man. And they faced Harry Smith, which is obviously British Bulldog's son, and Lance Archer, Lance Hoyt, whatever his name is.
Yep, we were talking about him earlier.
Yep. They faced off in a pretty good match, and I believe I posted some footage from the match on the THT Podcast Facebook, which
you can go to
facebook.com.
Yep, I was watching those as you were posting them. They were good stuff, man.
There you go, man. Facebook.com/group/THT podcast. Go on there if you want to check out some of the footage. They power bombed him through a table on the match, which was a pretty good match. Next one, we got Austin Aries against Drew Galloway, which is AKA Drew McIntyre. Man, this guy is huge in person. I didn't realize how big he is.
He's like 6'4", dude.
Yeah, he's fucking big.
That's why I can't believe WWE did what they did to him. He's like WWE material. He's 6'4". He's 200 and some pounds.
Dude, I think he's bigger than 6'4". I have a buddy of mine who's 6'4", and this guy seemed like a fucking giant.
Well, let's see.
Maybe it's because he was standing next to Austin Aries, though. I don't know.
Maybe. Well, yeah. Good point.
That's probably why. But this was actually pretty good match, pretty hard hitting match. Actually, they were working really stiff.
He's 6, by the way.
How much?
He is Drew Galloway is 6'6".
Yeah, he's a big guy, man. Big fucking guy, and he knows how to carry himself like a giant. He's the type of guy that's actually tall, and he still walks on his footsteps. On his tiptoes. And you know, he carries himself like a giant. The way he poses, the way he walks, you know, he has that giant like ability, the strength, everything. He's good, man. And definitely a stiff match. It almost seemed like a New Japan match or something. They were very hard hitting. Not too many high spots, not too many dives, nothing like that. But the thing that surprised me is Drew Galloway, he was working as a heel, and this guy was gold as a heel. I mean, he was cursing everybody off. He was going out there shaking up the fucking the guardrails and everything. He was good, man. I'd never seen him like this. So I was excited. It was good stuff.
Good. I liked him. I was a little shocked when WWE booted him.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know why they did that. But then we got Joey Matthews. Was that his name? Joey the guy from ECW. He went to TNA afterwards.
Yeah, I see where you're at now.
Joey Matthews. I think that was his name. Joey. No, Christian York. That's his name. Christian York.
Oh, okay. I know who he is.
Yeah. Christian York, he faced Brian Myers, a.k.a. Curt Hawkins, and Curt Hawkins was the heel this time. So he him and Drew McIntyre, they both pretty much did a 360, and they were carrying themselves as heels. And I think it worked, man. Christian York, he came out really expecting to be over with the crowd, and you know, because he's a former ECW guy. He started out in ECW, and I don't think many people recognized who he was. Nobody really gave a shit. It was kind of silent. And it was an all right match. Nothing spectacular. It wasn't bad. But afterwards, Brian Myers basically put out an open challenge, and that's when Ricardo Rodriguez came out, and to a huge pop because it was a surprise. And after that, Alberto Del Rio came out, which, man, this, I did not think that people were gonna like this guy that much, dude. You just heard a huge roar in the crowd. It was awesome. And he basically came out and he basically said, fuck the WWE. They told me that I can't wrestle in the States for a fucking year. And these are straight quotes. And I quote, he said the WWE is pussies. And that's when a fuck McMahon chant broke out in the ECW arena. And man, was it loud. Fuck McMahon. We got fuck McMahon for about 4 minutes straight. And he was loving it, man. I mean, Del Rio, you can tell, I wasn't the biggest Del Rio fan, but man, I grew a whole new amount of respect for this guy. Just because when he came out to the arena, dude, you could tell he was legitimately excited to be there. You know, he wanted to be there. Clearly he's not getting that much money, if any money, to come out there. Cause from my understanding, he was doing some stuff with Rob Feinstein. So he was already in town. So I don't know. It made an appearance or what, but he was really excited. He shook everybody's hands that was on, you know, ringside. And you know, again and again, he put over the ECW arena, and he said, you know, how proud he is to be able to, you know, enter this arena and be here. And this is a big moment in his career to finally be able to step in this building. And, you know, he was really just over with the crowd, man. They fucking loved him, and he just, I don't know. Just basically just shit on the WWE. That's a bit, you know, in simple form. But it was good stuff.
Bobby Roode was there?
Bobby Roode was there. He showed up as another surprise.
ECW, EC3's replacement was Bobby Roode.
Yeah, he faced Tommy Dreamer, and actually the TNA belt was up for grabs in the match, so he defended the title there. So that was pretty good.
Velvet Sky was there.
Yeah, and then Velvet Sky actually, she interfered in the Bobby Roode and Tommy Dreamer match, and she had a cat fight with Beulah, and then we had the Sandman show up in the middle of the match, and C.W. Anderson came out, and then Spike Dudley came out. It was a whole clusterfuck, but
Dudley Rosita came out.
Yeah, she came out, and she got Tommy Dreamer pile-drived her, and yeah, pretty much the whole locker room came out, and it was just a bunch of surprises. I mean, half the people that came out weren't even supposed to be there.
I know you're talking, and I'm reading, I'm listening, but I'm reading, and I'm like, this show looks fucking awesome.
It was, man. It was good stuff. Really good stuff.
Now, you gotta tell me how Sandman looked and was. I gotta know.
Terrible as always.
Awesome. Awesome. As long as he's not looking good, I'm happy.
And one thing I want to go ahead and say, man, please, if anybody ever listens to this that has anything to do with House of Hardcore or any of these shows, you know, I'm not trying to shit on the Sandman, but, dude, we've already seen it, because I've been at every single House of Hardcore that was in Philadelphia, so I think there was a total of 4 of them so far. Every single time Sandman makes an appearance during the Tommy Dreamer match. And it's kind of repetitive. It's like, all right, man, I've seen this guy enough. He doesn't wrestle anymore. He comes in, he canes one guy, and he leaves. All right, we get it. We've seen enough of it. He looks horrible. He can barely walk. It's just, I don't know. I'm not really into it. Like, him and Raven, I'm really just over it. I don't need to see guys like that. Like, Balls Mahoney, all these guys, they can go. I'm good.
I can kind of see where you're going there. Man, this show must have been fucking badass.
It was, man. Actually, Stephen McBreen was also there from our Facebook page.
Oh, I saw you guys were get where we're going. That's fucking awesome, dude.
Yeah, so I took a buddy of mine up there for the first time to a wrestling show. That was his first time. He seemed like he was kind of bored, but then again, he's not the biggest wrestling fan. So, you know, you really got to be into wrestling to go to, like, independent shows and really appreciate it.
Yeah, and especially with all these people coming out, that if you're not a wrestling fan, you're just going to be like, who's this fucking guy coming out?
Right.
Right. I get it. I would be a little bored, too, if I didn't know, but being a wrestling fan, I'm reading these fucking results, and I'm fucking pissed I don't live where you live right now.
You can get the iPay-per-view.
I will. I'm going to, I'll get it my way, but,
There you go, man. Yeah, fuck all that. But,
don't worry, I'll buy it, too. I will pay for it when it comes out. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, I've got all the shows on Blu-ray so far. I like to always buy the shows that I'm at. Kind of just, you know, remember all the shows that I've gone to.
Yeah, this show looked like it was great, man. And from what I hear, every time I hear about one of these House of Hardcore shows, I don't hear bad things. I always hear good stuff, and goddamn, this dude needs a fucking TV deal.
I think he's going to get one, man. I mean, I would not be surprised if Tommy Dreamer makes this happen, because, like I said, I've been to every single one, and there hasn't been a bad one. I mean, people come out happy, and it's a different vibe, and you can tell people are trying to help him out, because people, and you gotta keep in mind, man, this is Philadelphia, this is where ECW was born. For people to stop doing ECW chants at your show and start doing HOH chants, they have to kind of respect you and want to give you that push, like, okay, this is something new.
Mm-hmm.
And let's face it, HOH isn't the catchiest, you know, chant to get over with the crowd.
True.
So, and another thing, they need a new name, man. I mean, House of Hardcore, I don't know. But, yeah.
Let's face it, it's better than TNA.
Yeah.
it is.
Yeah. But the thing that surprised me is how much the Philadelphia crowd hated Bobby Roode. I mean, man, everybody booed the shit out of him.
Really?
That dude, they hated him. They hated anything TNA. The whole time, all you heard was fuck Dixie Chance and fuck TNA and all this stuff. It was just, they hated TNA.
It sounded like he came out and trashed Dixie a little bit.
I don't know. I kind of...
He didn't see eye to eye, as it says. It doesn't say he trashed it.
Yeah. But, they definitely booed the hell out of him, which really surprised me, because at first when he came out, he was over, and then a couple minutes later, he just heard roars of just boos, just constant boos, and,
Rude put the TNA title on the line at this show?
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Oh my god, I thought you meant Dreamer put the title on. Wait a minute.
He put the TNA title against Dreamer.
A title on the line. Wow.
Yeah, it was a good show, man. It was big. And they had a sold out crowd, dude. They had they had probably a good 15, 16, maybe 1700 people there. And that's not bad for ECW arena. They can't fit 2000 people.
That's not bad at all. Dude, TNA would kill for that shit.
Yeah, it was good, man, and the crowd was into it. It was really decent. And there was actually some rappers there, some random ass fucking New York rappers that are actually like semi-famous. I didn't really know them, but I guess they were getting a lot of attention.
That's cool, man. And then, let's see, what do we got left here? Oh, I'm hitting it. You ready?
Got the main event.
This show deserved the sound drop.
It did, man. Honestly, this match was fantastic. And as it should have been, as I expected. Bucks from the Bullet Club against the Hardys, which is an absolute dream match. I don't care what anybody says. This is a dream match, dude. I don't care. This is a dream match. And, dude, the Hardys got booed. They hated Jeff Hardy. They hated Matt Hardy. And you can tell, like, Matt Hardy was kind of used to it because he was doing the Extreme Rising shows and he was always getting booed in Philadelphia. But you can tell Jeff Hardy was not used to it. He's used to the TNA crowds. He doesn't do indies really. This is his, you know, first indie appearance other than the stuff that he's doing for his own promotion. But, he was kind of caught off guard and he didn't really know how to react to it. But, yeah, Matt Hardy, he started playing up to it and he started acting like a heel. And, you know, he cheated a couple times in the match. Although, you know, the Young Bucks were technically supposed to be the heels since, you know, Bullet Club. But, yeah, the Young Bucks were getting huge chance. And I think I posted some of that footage up there and that, you know, people were saying fuck the Hardys and just completely shitting on the Hardys. But this match was awesome, dude. Awesome, awesome. All plenty of high spots. 1,001 super kicks as I expected. Just a high spot, fucking fuckfest. That's pretty much what it was. It sounded like a gangbang, but it wasn't. It was just a good wrestling show. But yeah, it was really good, man.
Good, man. I'm glad you fucking had a good time. It looks like I said, it looked like an awesome show from just by the results of it.
Oh yeah, and the Young Bucks, man. These guys, I've seen them probably a good 10 times, and you know, live. And these guys are getting better every show. So, and I know they have no interest in going to the WWE or TNA. They've let it be known. So, but they definitely have some bright futures as far as, you know, just remaining on the indies, I guess, and Japan, which I guess it pays the bills. They're happy. So.
Yeah. And they were in TNA for a while.
Right. And they hated it, and they got tryouts in the WWE. And they hated how corporate it is and how you had to act certain ways in the locker room and, you know, all that shit. And, you know, if you see these guys a lot, you can tell they're just some young guys. They don't give a fuck. They're just out there to act reckless and act like some idiots and have fun. You can tell that they're out there, you know, really to have fun. They really don't care. They're not trying to carry themselves or their persona in a certain way. They don't, you know, you can tell they don't want to go to the WWE and be under all these restrictions. So, really, they're doing well on the indies and Japan especially, and, you know, of course, New Japan is probably the second biggest wrestling promotion. So,
not bad.
Not bad, man. Damn, I really wish I could have gone to that. I wish I lived near you so I could have gone to that show, man.
Yeah, man, it was a good show, man. Good show. And I think Ring of Honor is actually coming out here pretty soon.
Nice. Yeah, our chat room is saying that Tommy should get away from that hardcore and extreme and all those names and come out with something fresh.
Yeah, because they don't do anything hardcore, you know? It's not really a hardcore promotion at all. I mean, that match was supposed to be a hardcore match, and it really wasn't. There was nothing hardcore in that match until the end. They pulled out a barbed wire board, and, you know, Tommy Dreamer got, like, body slammed onto it. But, you know, they can just eliminate that because it's not a big spot anyway. Like, you know, unless you're doing something crazy with the barbed wire. I mean, I can really do without a body slam on a barbed wire board and just...
Yeah, a hardcore match last night on TNA with Bram.
I like Bram, man. He's awesome.
They were bleeding. You need to check out last night's TNA then, because they were bleeding all over. They were both bleeding like motherfuckers, dude.
Who was he against?
Bram. Bram and Tommy Dreamer.
Oh, shit. Nice. I got to check it out then.
I mean, they broke out chairs wrapped in barbed wire and shit. It was a good match, man.
Nice. You barely see that anymore, man. Even on the indies, they don't really do any hardcore stuff.
Yeah, TNA's got, right now, they're kind of using Magnus and Bram as their hardcore guys, and I hope they don't can keep doing it because it's kind of ruining those two guys, but I don't know.
I like a hardcore division, though. I think it helps. Maybe not the same guys every time, but...
That's right now what it's ended up being. It's the same two guys against the same two guys. So...
All right, take over for 1 second. Just give me 1 second here.
All right. Take over. We've talked about every goddamn thing there is. What the fuck? Take over. I don't know what the hell I'm going to say. Could talk more about this Furniture Smackdown with Roddy Piper and Ken Anderson. I don't want to do that. That just sounds horrible. So what can we talk about?
Well, I am back.
Oh, good.
Well, you had nothing to talk about, I heard. But, yeah, House of Hardcore was awesome, man. For anybody that wants to check it out, definitely check it out. Support these good indies, you know, Pro Wrestling Syndicate, House of Hardcore. I guess Extreme Rising is coming back under the name of Land of Extreme, which is really odd. I don't know how that's going to get over. But Steve O'Neill, if you're behind this project, a big fuck you to you. I hope I don't see this guy. Fuck this guy. Don't support Steve O'Neill. Fuck that guy. Once again, fuck Steve O'Neill. Don't support that guy. So I hope he's not behind Land of Extreme. But, yeah, support good indies, man. Ring of Honor, all these other ones. PWG, Pro Wrestling Guerrilla, all the other good stuff. Chikara, Evolve, Dragon Gate, all that good stuff, man.
There you go. Yeah, man. I really wish some more of it came here, man.
Yeah. Yeah, I hear you, man.
Really do, but I think someone told me there's a show coming about 45 minutes from me. So, I don't know. I'm going to see what can be done if I can get out there. Luke Cox usually goes to those shows, so.
Yeah, he's awesome, man. That's another guy. I don't get it. Why doesn't somebody just sign him? Ring of Honor, Lucha Underground, WWE.
I don't think he wants to, man. I think he's happy training, and I think when his guys get signed is when he's happier. From all the interviews I've heard, that's about how he sounds.
I don't know, man. I'm sure he's open to you know, signing to a big company. I mean, why wouldn't he?
I don't know. I mean, I don't know why you wouldn't be, but I don't know, man. It's just... I don't know.
Yeah. By the way, Luke Hawks is a really good guy, man. Good guy. Support his Wildcats shows if you guys live around the Louisiana area. Good guy, man. Good wrestler.
Yeah, I've talked to him on Facebook once or twice. He does seem like a really cool, down-to-earth, honest guy.
Yeah. He almost killed my ex at the first Extreme Rising show, but I saw him a couple times afterwards, and we spoke, and he's a really good guy.
Yeah, he seems like it. Seems like a cool guy, so.
Yeah, but he almost took out the first front row and almost killed all of us. So.
You would have been fine.
Yeah, probably not. But
you would have had a good story to tell, at least.
We would have, because he was really reckless. Yeah, it is what it is, man. But I guess that's about it, man. We've talked about everything, literally.
We did.
Been here 3 hours.
But now, we did miss one huge piece of news.
What is that?
It looks as if Eva Marie has gotten breast implants.
Oh, tits.
And if you didn't see the pictures, trust me, she got breast implants, and damn, does she look good.
Do you think Dean Ambrose touched them yet?
Dude, he's going to master them. If he doesn't master them, I'll be upset.
He probably will.
Even though she's married, girls that get new boobs love their new boobs.
Yeah, that guy's a cornball.
He seems all right.
He cries all the time, dude.
Who, her husband?
Yeah.
He actually seems, to me, he's like a nicer version of the situation from Jersey Shore.
Then again, you enjoy the Jersey Shore. I didn't, so that might explain.
I did. Meanwhile, that jerk-off mic is...
the situation.
A lot of taxes. He didn't pay his taxes.
Oh, what an idiot.
You cannot do that. Hold on. I'm going to post this picture right in the old chat room for these people.
What an idiot.
I agree.
I might go to the CZW show also. Cage of Death.
Nice.
That's going to be insane. That's not really near me. That's in New Jersey, about an hour away. It might be worth it, though.
That's not bad. I would drive an hour.
Yeah. Cage of Death is pretty insane, too. I went to the Tournament of Death last year in Delaware, and this is right up there with it. Cage of Death is, I'm sure, I think you're not really familiar with CZW, but if you put it in YouTube, they have like these like really shitty cages, and inside it is pretty much just tons of light tubes and glass and tables and barbed wire and all kinds of shit. And yeah, it's really gruesome, but it's once a year. They go all out and they pretty much kill each other. So
that's why it's once a year.
Yeah, so I might go there. It might be worth it. I don't know.
Go for it, man.
Yeah, why not?
Go for it. Like I said, I think like there's some, and I forget what they call it. I found a company here called, I want to say Texas Stampede Wrestling, but I don't want to be a moron. So give me 1 second to get on Facebook here. Duplicate that tab. Let me see if that's it, because I think it was called Texas Stampede Wrestling.
Yeah.
Texas... It pulls up. Texas Stampede Wrestling. That's exactly what it's called. I don't know. It's part of NWA. So I don't know, but I don't know any of these people they got pictures posted of.
Ah, man. And NWA has been dead for 30 years.
Yeah, it's a.
I hated all those knockoffs, of NWA. The only one that was decent was pretty much TNA when they first started and Wildside, NWA Wildside. That was pretty decent. They had like AJ Styles and Sabu and I think Ruckus and just a bunch of random people. And I think Abyss actually started out there, Stone Mountain.
Yeah, they're going to call this NWA Smath, blah, 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 blah.
Math Mouth?
Smash Mouth. Wrestling, which completely reminds me of XFL.
Man,
They're actually gonna. It's gonna all be in North Texas, which I live in North Texas, with the debut of NWA Smash Mouth coming to the Metroplex for 2015. Dude, I'm just happy there's gonna be some wrestling here.
Yeah, but if you don't know anybody off the card, it's kind of
okay. They got Teddy Hart.
Nice. Well, actually, that's decent.
Hold on, let me pull this picture up, because I got Teddy Hart. I see Teddy Hart. Who else do I see here that I know? That's about it.
Well, that's, I don't know if I would go to that if you just, if it's just Teddy Hart.
It's the only fucking wrestling around here right now, man. I'm telling you, man. I mean, Raw's coming back here in a little while. Or is it Raw? Or...
Wait for that. I can't go to indies. Like, you know, like the real small independents where you just don't know anybody. I can't do those shows, dude. I can't watch those.
Yeah. That's it, though. This is, they are going to be NWA Smash Mouth.
Yeah, I have to go to the semi-big indies, like, you know, like Ring of Honor and stuff like that.
Oh, wait a minute, dude. There's a whole other company I just found. And this is in Sherman. My sister lives exactly 20 minutes from Sherman.
Nice.
It's about an hour and a half from me. Oh, man, I'm finding wrestling on this page. I might find some local wrestling, man.
There you go, man.
Like, Cowboy James Claxton.
Speaking of local wrestling, I guess Jersey All Pro Wrestling has also returned, and that's the birthplace to, you know, Homicide and fucking Low-Key and Dan Moff, all those guys. And they actually they had a return show, so that they're back. That's good.
Huh? Wow, they got Barbie Hayden too. Sorry. I'm excited to find any local wrestling because I haven't been able to find it here in years. Looks like I'm gonna have to wait till next year to get it. But
there you go, man.
Yeah, they got Luke Hawks on a couple of posters, so hopefully he'll be down here when this promotion starts up again.
Nice.
I hope he will be. Well, I do.
Let's get our plugs in and let's get the hell out of here, man.
Yeah, let's do it. I've been working since 7 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, let's get out of here. We've been here long enough.
Yeah, we've been here long enough. Let's do it.
Twitter page. Go ahead and follow us on Twitter, THT Podcast. You can follow me on Twitter at I don't even know my Twitter fucking handle. I think it's at S Shagan. S-S-H-A-Y-G-A-N. And you can also join us on Facebook, facebook.com/group/THT podcast. You can join us on iTunes. Please go ahead and subscribe on there, as it always helps us. And it's called THT Wrestling Podcast, as well as YouTube. If you're watching it live right now, you obviously know where we're at. It's the Turnbuckle Corner or THT Wrestling Podcast. And I believe that's it. You can also check it all out at the wrestling website that we have, which is hottagpodcast.weebly.com. That is a lot of goddamn plugs.
Yeah, you're right. And I'm on Twitter, too, besides THT Podcast. I'm at BoxmanTHT, one word.
There you go, man. Give us a follow. And if you have any questions, any topics that you want us to discuss next week, go ahead and leave a message on the Facebook or Twitter or I don't know, however you want to contact us. Really doesn't matter. Leave a comment on the YouTube page. Go ahead and give a subscription to the YouTube page as well. And I think that's about it. We've talked long enough.
Yeah. I just want to, I don't know, everybody start helping us out. Start getting some people listening to us, more people listening to us. We do want to get this thing kind of growing if we can. And unfortunately, we both have regular jobs, so it's kind of tough for us to do this. So give us some help. We'll find some ways to reward you people in the near future.
There you go, man. Yeah, give us some help by sharing it. Share it on any wrestling form that you know that people might want to listen, and et cetera.
Now that we got all the audio issues worked out, since everyone can hear me now, and they couldn't for the first, 8-9 shows, so we got all that worked out, and we're not touching settings, so it's going to be like this every time. So get us, tell your friends, get us big, get us huge.
There you go, man. We're here to crush. Rusev Crush.
Rusev Crush.
Rusev Crush.
All right, now we're here to get out of here.
All right, let's get the fuck out of here.
I'm still staring at...
Fuck out of here, man.
I'm still staring at Eva Marie's giant tits.
We got to get the fuck out of here.
You just want to get out of here, don't you?
We got to get the fuck out of here.
Come on, man. I'm sitting here. All I'm thinking is two things.
Boobies.
And...
I see titties and beer.
Titties and beer.
Titties and beer.
Beer. See, you're hungry for vagina right now. I'm hungry for food, man. I'm starving. I'm probably hungry for both, but rather have some food.
All right. Well, let's get this shit. Let's get the hell out of here. That was it. Plugs are here. We will be back Tuesday. This was a special edition. Shaheen's had some stuff to do. I had some stuff to do. Wednesday night, I had more stuff to do. I had to be at my kid's school, so... We will be back next Tuesday. We will have, hopefully Shaheen will watch the new Lucha Underground. I'll get it put on the Google Drive for us.
There you go.
We'll talk Raw.
There you go. THT Podcast. We'll be back next week.
THT Podcast. See y'all Tuesday.
Back around, good man. Time to kick back, take some business, smoke some weed.
See ya.
See ya.